There once was a man named Gold Roger, who was king of the pirates. He had fame, power, and wealth beyond your wildest dreams. Before they hung him from the gallows, these were the final words he said.
My fortune is yours for the taking, but you'll have to find it first. I left everything I own in one piece.
Guess I'm not knowing what is wrong, what is right. Within the bitterness of darkness, I minimize my role. Every new beginning slowly tears my soul apart. And when the enemy surrounds me, I will break down the walls. And if I have to run against the wind, I'll give it my all. Just listen closely to the beating of the flaming heart that still keeps on moving onward. Suddenly I fear a gritty cat of death that's calling out to me. Do you believe yourself now?
Creep.
Let go of me.
Wait.
But you will have to go inside.
I think he's gonna fucking eat me.
I accept this quest.
You truly are the sin of greed.
Are you ready for this challenge? Because if you do fail, you will have the same fate as all of us.
Well, if this thing eats me, I'm sure I'll be dead anyway. So, let's go.
It ate our anchor, so now it is our anchor.
I can't swim, though, so I don't know why you're asking me to do
that. Zoros, do you know what type of...
They actually don't know that.
Octopus,
yeah,
this is...
I'm gonna die! It's gonna eat me!
Is it like some sort of squid or octopus or something?
So can you tell the rest of the crew what the hell the ghost said?
Well, if they left the ship, they have no idea what's happening to you.
Yeah, you gotta come up here.
Okay, I'm going upper to the upper decks, then.
Alright. Wait, so are we all...
You agreed to help them.
Okay. Yes.
Creep, we're on the ship. Oh, yeah, I guess...
Do you guys know that Groby's in the water?
Yeah, I'll go and get him.
Come on, Groby, okay. Get out of there.
Groby, I need you to give me... A dexterity saving throw with disadvantage. With disadvantage, one more. Oh, nice. So, you break free as another tentacle tries to wrap around you. And Dan jumps into the water.
Nope!
Come on, we're going.
Dan, I need you to give me a dexterity saving throw with disadvantage.
I have disadvantage?
Yes. Because you're trying to help Groby, so therefore, it's harder for you to get away.
Mm.
It tries to wrap you up.
Okay.
After missing him. Oh. Dan fails, and is now being pulled to the mouth of the beast.
No! We're getting away from
okay,
me.
Can I do a strength save?
You can either attack the tentacle, but if you do, if you break free from it, it's already latched onto you.
Uh-huh.
So like an octopus suction cups or...
Yeah.
They'll do damage to you if you break free.
Can I yell to him saying there's treasure in the belly of the beast and just let it happen?
I will do. Is the octopus unarmored?
It is very armored.
Well, I mean, does it have armor?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Normally, octopuses don't, but this one is more than just an octopus.
Okay, I will do Tidal Wave Fist.
Alright. Ooh, unfortunately that doesn't hit. It has an AC of 20.
It has an AC of 20?
Yep.
That's a high AC!
Oh, well, low tide, or what is it? Tidal Wave Fist is a area of effect attack.
Yeah, if you hit. See how the 19? But I'm sure you still send a wave, regardless if you hit.
Yeah.
So, 16. It has a plus 4 to strength. So it does take the 9 force range.
Okay, so it gets pushed away?
Yeah, but you're still wrapped up in it.
Well, I can breathe underwater for quite a long time, but... The problem is the thing.
Yeah, it's dragging you down to its mouth.
Yeah.
Oh no, Dan! I'll jump in and help.
The kid?
No kid. August grabs the kid. He's like, "You're not going."
Get a gun! Get a gun! A big gun!
Okay.
The crew on your guys' ship are like, "Should we shoot cannons at it? What do we do?"
Yeah, probably.
They're all looking at Kreeth because he's the second in command. What do we do?
Let him get eaten. There's treasure in there.
They all smack their heads at once. Pierre's like, "Sign me up." He jumps in.
Good job, Pierre. Go for it. I can't swim.
Okay,
I'm not getting in that water.
They all the ghosts that are surrounding. They all go to the top level of the deck. Like they all float up and they're surrounding you. They're
okay.
Like,
do
you
I hit him now?
Get our cap. What?
Do I hit now?
Can't just go again.
Oh, I have multiple attacks though.
Well, I know this that was to break free.
Oh, okay.
That was break free. Yeah. So like now we're all gonna roll initiative.
Oh, okay, makes sense.
Grilby, you have disadvantage on initiative.
Okay, how do I roll that again on this?
I can technically. I think I've calculated Dan's how long he can hold his breath, and it's like.
Don't I roll it on roll 20 so that it adds me in the order?
Okay, so, Dan, it's uh-huh. your constitution modifier
uh-huh.
times 10. That's how,
Well, he also has stuff that increases how long he can breathe. I think it, like, yeah, Fishman Karate, it, like, doubles it, so it'd be con plus what?
Your con modifier.
Yeah. Where's that at?
Then...
Plus 3?
Is that what it is? Plus 3?
Is that the saving throw?
The con modifier, plus 3.
Uh-huh.
And then, whatever your Fishman Karate...
It doubles whatever it is.
So, 6 minutes is how long you can hold your breath.
Yeah.
Ooh, grow B. Not good.
But in D&D time,
you guys,
it's quite a long time.
Yeah, that's quite a long time, especially in a battle, but...
Darn! What the hell?
This is a bad idea.
How did you get a 0? Oh, okay, I was like, what? Do I roll initiative?
Yeah, you're the only one that hasn't rolled initiative. And you would have disadvantage because you're tangled up.
Okay. Okay, so I guess 11.
Yep, which is not bad. Yeah. Alright, the monster has plus 1 to initiative. So it goes
about Pierre.
Okay, so
Pierre?
It's Kreeth first. Yeah, Pierre jumped in.
Yeah, Pierre's in the water.
He has a plus 2 to initiative. He's 14. And the monster has a plus 1, so he goes at 12.
Okay, I guess we're fighting a giant kraken.
Let it eat you.
No. Why?
There's treasure in it.
Yeah, you let him eat you then.
I can't fucking swim.
Yeah.
That's your problem.
Yeah, that's all you, Kreeth. My sin is wrath, not greed. So, I mean, Dan's a little greedy, but he's not enough to fucking dive into a monster's mouth to get money.
Well, Pierre's going down there, so I don't know if you guys just want to let him die.
Yeah.
The rest of the crew will go after you guys, and they can shoot cannons if you want.
Yeah.
August isn't going to jump in
uh-huh.
the water.
Yeah.
But you notice that there are 4 tentacles outside of the water, and Dan is wrapped around one.
So it has 5 tentacles?
Well, you guys know of 5.
Okay.
Each tentacle has armor class of 20 and 30 health.
Okay. What about the body? What's the armor class on the body?
You would have to get down there and then nature check that.
Okay.
But I think the armor class for the body is the same.
Okay.
Just more health.
I guess it's you, Kreeth, and then Pierre, then the monster, then me.
Can't do much other than, like, either go back...
Oh, what's the rest of the crew's initiative? Like, are they just after everyone?
They go after you guys, and then they'll shoot, because you guys only have 3 cannons on the side, they'll shoot 3 cannons at the ship with the tentacles.
Okay. Kreeth, I don't know what you're gonna do.
Well, right now the spirits say that if I fail, they're gonna kill me, so...
You can't fucking swim, so you can't jump in. I guess you gotta fucking... Oh, you have a... You have a...
We're dead, man.
You have a crossbow. Shoot the tentacle that's grabbing me.
Okay. It's in the water, so you will be shooting with disadvantage.
Yeah, no, that doesn't do
And then that one will hit Dan. You got disadvantage, so you get one more.
Wow. That would have worked. Yeah. You have two attacks, though.
All right.
So you could go again.
Wait, no. Kreeth only has one attack.
He doesn't have two attacks?
Nope. Rogues don't get
you. Yeah, you better save our ass!
Well, that sucks. I guess...
That's what I missed.
Kreeth shot an arrow into the water and it missed. That's pretty much it.
Yes. It is Pierre's turn, and he's gonna use his movement to attach himself to the tentacle that Dan is attached to, and he's gonna stab it.
Also, Kreeth, you do have...
dagger.
You do have that alchemist fire I gave you that you can put on your, crossbow, or whatever.
Yeah, but if I miss, that's going to be useless anyway.
And, yeah.
Yeah. He's going to try to hit this thing. A nat 20 is a guaranteed hit. Nat 1, he is stabbing Dan.
Come on, Pierre.
He's got a...
Wait, how close am I... How far am I under the water, then, if he's hitting me?
Okay.
You're just
under the water. Like, okay. It just pulled you down.
So I'm still, like, trying to fight up?
Every one of its turns, it's going to drag you down 30 more feet.
On my turn, can I use... a strength check to break out of it?
It goes before you, but...
Yeah.
And if he manages to hit it, mm-hmm. like beat the armor class, mm-hmm. it'll release you and wrap around Pierre.
Okay.
So here is his +2 dagger. It's not the armor class. As you see Pierre trying
to... Is Pierre a rogue?
Yeah.
Damn it, Pierre. Okay.
He's stabbing it, and he's like, it's not working! It is the squid kraken's turn.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna pull Dan 30 more feet down.
Mm.
And the other tentacles are going to attack Kreeth because he's the only one on the ship. So they have a +2 to hit.
Mm-hmm.
And if they do manage to hit you, Kreeth, they'll wrap you up and try to drag you down. So we got 4 tentacles and they got a +2. Oh my.
20 and 17 hit.
Yeah. So with the nat 20, it grips you up. Now you can either dexterity saving throw, try to avoid the 20, but the 17 is still gonna get you. Remember, you gotta beat a 22. You do not beat a 22. So you are wrapped
up. Ethan's gonna die.
You are wrapped up, and it does 2d4 damage. Nice. I only did 2 damage to you.
I'll take that.
And it is Dan's turn.
Okay, my turn. Let's do attacks. I'm gonna do...
You can use your action to try to break free.
Yeah.
But if you don't use your action, you'll have disadvantage. You don't break free.
Okay, I can use one of my things to try
one
to
of your,
break free.
One of your attack actions to break free. It'd be a strength saving throw.
Okay. I guess I will try that first. Please.
That does not pass.
Damn it. I guess I'm gonna try to attack it.
All right, so you got one attack then?
Yeah, plus my bonus hit. Okay. Nope.
17 does not hit. So you're punching this tentacle, trying to get it to let you go. And then your bonus action...
Still nothing. Okay.
Low rolls.
Yeah.
Oh, very no. Fleshy. Zoros. Zoros, it is your turn.
Yeah, Zoros, come and help me.
Zoros, you're only 30 feet away from Dan. Groby, you're on the same level as Zoros. Pierre is 10 feet below you guys, trying to stab the tentacle.
Zoros' swimming speed is like 40 feet, though, or something
yeah.
like that.
He should have no problem catching up.
Yeah.
Still grabbing my trident, and I try to stab the tentacle that's wrapped around Dan.
Okay. Now, if I remember right, you are a fighter, so by this level, you should have 2 attacks, yep.
Damn!
Yeah, there you go! Two-handed or one-handed?
Two-handed. Oh, actually, I have the feet and 19 strength, so I can do it one hand.
So you want to just use one hand? I just need to know this for clarifying, that you're using one hand to wield the trident. Alright, so you do 4 damage.
Wait, don't you get advantage when you're underwater? I don't remember your racial abilities. I think you get advantage underwater. I would look that real quick because you might get a nat 20.
Mm.
I know with Fishman Karate, I don't have disadvantage underwater, and I think the Fishman have advantage underwater. Because you normally would have disadvantage when you're underwater.
You mean racial traits.
Yeah, it'd be in racial traits.
Breathe, control, air and water, child of the sea, emissary of the sea. Aquatic beasts have an extraordinary affinity with your people, okay? adapted to even most extreme death. Okay, resist cold damage. You are stronger when underwater. All your stats increase by 1 when you're underwater. So he doesn't have advantage, as his stats are increased.
But he doesn't have disadvantage either, I think.
Yeah, he doesn't have disadvantage.
Okay, so wouldn't it be a +1 on his attack then? If it goes up by 1? Or no?
No, his strength score goes up by 1.
Yeah.
That doesn't change damage.
Okay.
Unless you're a barbarian, then that changes the damage, but he's not. So you stab it with your trident. It lets go of Dan and tries to wrap around you.
I give Zoros a thumb up, like a thumbs up.
Give me a dexterity saving throw. You just need to beat a 15, which you do not.
Hmm.
So now Zoros is wrapped up. Dan, you are free, but you are 30 feet below.
Yeah. Well, my swimming speed is 35, so I should be able to get back onto the surface.
And I'm not mistaken, but if Kreeth gets pulled underwater, he goes motionless, right?
Yeah.
He can't do anything.
Yeah, he can't really do much.
So on its next turn, he will be underwater.
It would be like being knocked prone, technically. Yeah.
Is that your turn, Zoros?
Yep.
You don't have
two attacks? No, you have a second attack.
Yeah, you have two attacks.
You can use your other attack to break free, or you can try to attack.
You can breathe underwater, though, so you're at a lot better than all of us.
Your second attack does not hit.
It's very fleshy.
So, Dan is 30 feet below you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Zoros is up top. Groby, you are at the same level as Zoros. What do you want to do?
No, Zoros is underwater, isn't he? Because he swam down to get me. So, Grill Bear would be above Zoros.
Yeah, I was just saying that, like, you guys are in the same vicinity.
Yeah,
vicinity.
Okay. I thought you meant that they were at the same
So, depth. Grillby rages. That is your bonus action.
Okay, and then can I Electra?
Oh.
Yes, you can. Go ahead, do it.
Does that hit us?
Yes.
Don't do that, please.
So, the 15 does not hit the squid's tentacle, but a constitution saving throw. It's got a +2. Otherwise, it takes 6 electric damage. It does pass the charisma save or constitution saving throw. Everyone else needs to make that too. Constitution saving
Wait, what did it 15. Roll? Oh, it says it's 4.
Constitution.
Yeah, but what did
the monster... +2. It has a +2.
So it got a 6?
Yeah, so it took 6 damage.
Oh, so is it paralyzed then?
Oh, it's not paralyzed.
Did it beat the 15?
No, I mean like it doesn't give him the stun, it just electrocutes him.
Oh, okay.
It does extra damage. See, if he would have hit the fist, then he would have done more damage.
Okay.
Groby, you don't have to make a constitution saving throw because you're immune to lick.
Yeah.
Nice.
But everyone else in the water has to make that.
Okay.
Dan is not even affected by it by the slightest.
Yeah.
I mean, I think we haven't been in the water yet, right?
Pierre has a -1.
I'm in the water.
So Pierre failed. Pierre failed. Zoros.
So he's paralyzed?
Yes. Pierre is paralyzed.
That's not amazing.
Fucked up.
Yeah. The octopus isn't paralyzed?
No. It's just you didn't hit.
Okay.
You didn't break the armor class.
So it wasn't
like
you shocked the tentacle.
Yeah.
And everybody around the tentacle. Zoros, did you make a constitution saving throw?
Hold on one second. What happened?
Girl B electrified the water.
Yeah.
Why?
I guess to try to paralyze the octopus.
If he would have beat that armor class, though, it would have been stunned. That tentacle would have just went limp.
Yeah. That octopus would be pretty fucked. You gotta make a con save, because it's in the water.
Zoros and Dan are unaffected by the electricity, as... Our poor defenseless Pierre starts to slowly descend.
Yeah. I'm still 30 feet. I was like, can I grab Pierre? But no, I'm 30 feet.
He's 10 feet above you, remember.
Yeah.
So by the time it is your turn again, he'll be down by you. Okay, it's everybody at the boat's turn, and they're going to try to hit the tentacles. That one will hit Kreeth. Mm. They get 4 shots.
Come on, take those tentacles off, man.
And they got to hit a 20. None of them hit.
Hmm.
Plus side, none of them hit Kreeth.
Yep. Okay. It's Grillbear's turn? No, wait.
It is Kreeth's turn.
Okay, yeah.
Kreeth, to break free before you get dragged to the depths after Pierre, you need a strength saving throw. If you do pass it, you will take a D4 damage.
But his devil fruit.
Okay, no. That is your action. You have a bonus action.
Yeah.
You have a bonus action.
You could strap the alchemist flame to you and
you can't do that with a bonus action.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, this is the last action I can do. Can I try and cut one of the
tentacles? No. You use your action trying to break free.
Okay.
You get a bonus act. Do you have any
bonus action? Is two weapon fighting. So if you were to attack with one of your weapons and you have another weapon, you could have done two attacks. You have cunning action, which allows you to disengage, hide, or dash, which I don't think any of those help right now. And fast dance.
Yeah.
And there's not much I can do practically. I mean, I can attack with my sword, I guess.
If you want to attack with your sword, you're still gripped though. You would have disadvantage.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Oh.
I end up stabbing myself.
Oh, you have disadvantage. You have disadvantage. You know, it can't get worse than that one though. So, you try to stab him with your sword, and you drop your sword on the ship. Sword.
Yay!
The cursed one or the regular one?
I do have an extra though, so it doesn't matter.
Wait, you do?
He has a cursed sword and then a regular sword. That's why he's two weapon fighting.
I had two cursed swords and then a scimitar, and I actually did buy an extra sword at the first session.
You gave it to the kid though.
Yeah, but I bought a couple of those.
Okay.
I didn't buy one.
Yeah. Okay, so you lost the short sword. It is Pierre's turn.
You also have the knife on your shoes.
Pierre's paralyzed.
He needs to make a constitution saving throw to get out of paralyzed. He has a minus one.
What did he get?
A nat one. He is paralyzed for the rest of this battle.
God damn, Pierre. Quit sucking so bad.
How long does your paralyze work? Doesn't it work last one turn, though?
Yeah, normally, but he rolled a nat one.
Oh, okay. So he's just really fucked.
Yeah. It is now the tentacle's turn. The
water made it stronger.
Zorels gets dragged down by 30 feet, and Kreeth is now inside the water.
Yeah, so
there are only three tentacles above water, and two of them are below.
Okay, great.
Zoros, it's going to constrict you, Zoros, while bringing you down.
I can't jump, but okay, go ahead.
Well, it's constricting you, so it's like squeezing you. It does 2d4.
Take 6 damage.
You take 6 damage. Alright, Dan, it's your turn. As the Kraken roars, hungry. It's been a while since it's 8.
How far are
Dan?
We?
Dan? What?
How far are we from the Kraken's mouth?
You won't be able to tell. But Dan and Zoros can give me a perception.
What did
check.
I miss? What did I miss, real quick?
Zoros took 6 damage.
Okay. How far under is he?
He is 30 feet.
Okay.
So he'd be like 10 feet below you.
Okay. And Kreeth is in the water?
Pierre is the same level as you.
Kreeth is in the water, right?
Yeah, I'm in the water. I can't do anything now.
Okay, it's my turn? Oh, you wanted us to roll a perception, right?
Yeah, you and Zoros can roll perception.
Yeah. Since we're swimming boys. Okay, I didn't see shit though. I'm good at swimming, but I'm still just a man.
you notice that the Kraken is only 70 feet below you guys.
Well, me and Zoros could probably go and fight it, but everyone else is pretty much fucked if it's 70 feet down.
Hey, what are they crushing levels for Dan then? What's
70 feet? 70 feet isn't that far down in the ocean.
It just sounds deep.
I think that, like, tons of people dive 70 feet. I can look up how far you can dive if you want.
Well, Zoros isn't affected by underwater pressure, but you are.
Yeah.
So is Pierre. Pierre's the same, level as you. The same level as you.
Most people...
He's just, like, floating down slowly.
It says the average person can do 60. So how much can a trained person?
Look up the trained diver. Which would be a dive master, by the way.
130 feet. And Dan's probably a little bit above a trained diver, so he's probably fine. The average person can do 60, and a trained diver can do 130, is what it says, where it's safe. So Dan's probably like...
So what's your move, Dan? What's your move? What are you going to do?
Well, Zoros, I could help him, but he can handle himself now. I should probably get the people that are drowning to death out of the water. Would be a good move.
Yeah, like Pierre and Kreeth.
Yeah.
Kreeth is at the surface of the water, so He's just being pulled down. Okay. Pierre is about 40 below surface.
Okay, so
Zoros is 30 feet below you.
Okay, so Pierre is closer than...
Pierre is on the same level as you.
Okay, so can I just grab Pierre then?
What's your swim movement?
Swim? 35 feet.
All right, so give me an athletics
uh-huh.
to grab Pierre and swim to the surface.
Okay, is that good?
Good. Okay, yeah. You swim to the surface with Pierre.
Can I throw... You know? Can I also...
Now, that would be your bonus action.
Yeah. With grabbing him, can I throw him onto the boat, or is that a different action?
No, that would require another bonus action or one of your attacks.
Okay. So I guess I'll just hold on to him for now. I will then use...
Or you can give him to Grill B.
Yeah. I'll just pass him to Grill B. Then I will...
He's your problem now, Grill B.
Then I will proceed to...
Oh no.
Three strike him with...
Are you striking the tentacle?
Yeah. That's holding.
Okay,
three.
See.
Okay, and then...
Okay, so you do only... 9 damage?
Well, I only did unarmed, so I get another one since I only did unarmed. Strike. Okay, well...
Now, remember, you don't have a bonus action, Dan. And
oh, okay.
If you go to your bonus action, it allows you to do Fury Blows, Hydro Knife, an extra unarmed strike. So you would only
ignore
get
that one.
Attacks. Yeah.
Well, I'd get 3 because it's all unarmed strike.
Your bonus action would be the third one. Does that make sense? You only get 2 per action.
Yes, okay.
And you used your bonus action to swim to the surface.
Okay, true. Just the 27, I guess, and the 18.
9 damage to the tentacle.
Oh, can I do the force damage? I'll use one of my slots and my gauntlet to do force damage. What is it,
okay,
D6?
Yeah, D6.
I will also...
So you did a total of 12 damage.
I will also use my crusher feet to knock him back, the tentacle back 5 feet.
Oh, well, I mean, that doesn't matter underwater.
Yeah, but it sounds cool.
however, uh-huh. Now because you did this, it's going to try to wrap you.
Okay.
So I need you to give me a dexterity saving throw. Creeth is free.
Please, be good. Is that good enough?
Wow. That is good enough. You need a 15.
Okay.
So neither one of you are entangled by...
Okay.
But Creeth is unconscious?
Well, yeah.
While he's in water?
But he probably just fell next to me, so I could probably just reach and grab him.
Yeah, but you don't have any more actions to use.
Yeah.
Well, that means I'm slowly sinking.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. But I saved both of you.
All right. It is Zoros' turn. Zoros, what are you doing?
The surgery is now worth a headache.
Yeah.
Go ahead and try and break free.
Strength saving throw? Now remember, if you break free, you take damage. You break free, so you...
Yeah, man!
Take 2d4 damage.
A fishman's strength, man.
4 damage.
Take 4 damage. You are free. Now, that was one of your attacks. Like one more attack.
Moving out of here.
So you want to swim 40 feet up?
Yep.
Okay, nice. So we should all get onto the ship then.
It's bad if you... It's bad, or anywhere else?
Grill Bear, can you throw Creeth and Pierre back onto the ship?
Wait, are you going to attack, or what are you doing, Zoros?
Yeah, what's your...
Get out of here. It is not worth it.
Because you got an attack and a bonus action.
You could grab Creeth.
Let's be fast. Oops.
Okay, so I have Pierre, you have Creeth. And then Grill Bear's just floating in the water. It's your turn.
I thought I had Pierre.
Oh yeah, I gave you Pierre. Okay. So yeah, I guess get Pierre onto the ship. Is it Grill Bear's turn?
Yeah, if Zoros isn't going to do anything else. Because you still have an attack.
Can he jump onto the ship with Creeth?
Give me athletics.
If he attacks the thing, it's just going to wrap around it.
Okay, that's good enough to get you on the ship. Now, unfortunately, you are closer to the pirate ship than the other ship. You get back on the pirate ship.
Which pirate ship? Ours or the...
The other one. Okay. The broken down one.
Okay.
And it is Groby's turn. Groby, what are you doing?
You gonna get Pierre on the ship? Or no?
What ship are you going to head to?
Muted.
You're 25 feet away from your guys' ship.
Yeah, you were muted.
Okay, theoretically, am I big enough to fit Pierre into my overalls while he's unconscious and then proceed to fight the octopus with him just strapped to me?
Yes, but he will drown in a minute.
Oh, okay, I'll just throw him up there then. What do I roll? Strength or, like...
Athletics. And that will take up one of your attack odds.
Okay.
Come on, Grill Bear.
Just need a 12. Athletics. You throw him up, he hits the side of the ship and falls back into the water.
I mean, this is hilarious.
Can I do it again?
You know what? Yeah, go ahead. But that's both of your attacks. You fail again.
Yeah.
You do it again. He hits the side of the ship and falls back down into your arms.
Is he conscious now?
He is not.
Well, he wasn't unconscious before. He was just paralyzed. Now he's definitely unconscious.
Yeah, because I just smacked against the side of the ship.
Yeah, he's definitely unconscious now.
Oh, no, he's fine. He looks okay, guys. He
takes 2d4 damage.
He said, "Hot Dan.
Come on, Tyr.
You know, I would find this humorous, but now is not really the time.
Okay, that's your turn. It is the crew's turn, and they're gonna fire 4 cannons.
Please, God. Whatever the one piece God is.
Nat one will hit one of you guys.
Please, one piece God.
And they need a 20. They have a +1, so 19 will work.
Though considering I've seen Bibles in One Piece, the One Piece God is probably just the same.
Oh God.
Ah, there's a 1 there.
Did they hit them at all?
They did not hit the tentacles, but one of them hit you, Dan.
Me?
Yes.
Okay.
This is 2d10s damage. So, take 15 damage.
That's great. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate that.
Hendrix is like, oh, sorry, that was me. My bad. All right, Dan. I'm trying to hit that tentacle, man.
Damn it, Hendrix.
All right, Kreeth.
I just got shot in the face with a cannonball.
You are not unconscious, Kreeth. What do you want to do?
The
ghosts are all surrounding you. The ghosts.
Well, he's out of the water. Is he unconscious? If he's not.
No, he's not. He's not unconscious.
Okay.
He's on the pirate ship. And they're all looking at him. All the ghosts are like, are you going to get our captain out of the Kraken's mouth?
I don't think I can.
And the treasure? The treasure in the Kraken's belly?
How good is your... What is your range on your crossbow, man?
Like 100 feet, I think.
You can
Once it hits water, you get disadvantage.
I mean, I can try. I'll fire at one of the tentacles again.
Yeah. Just hit the one that's on the land. Don't shoot
on
the
water. Hang on. Don't piss off the beast. It's kind of our fault why it's mad. The anchor's stuck in its mouth. We can't get it out.
What are they saying, Kreeth?
They say we need to get the anchor out of the Kraken's mouth. That's why they pissed it off. That's why it's mad.
How are they gonna get the anchor out of its fucking mouth?
Well, I don't know. You're the one that can breathe underwater.
It's definitely down to me and you, I guess, Thoros. You want to do rock, paper, scissors on this one?
Sure, whatever.
I don't know how... I don't know how we would decide that in real life.
Roll 1d20, whether it has all those skills.
Okay. Well, I guess you gotta beat a 7.
What the command again, Zoros?
Beat a 7?
Yeah, well, Zoros.
The command?
Wait, hang on, Zoros. You don't even wanna do this.
Well, we agreed to rock, paper, scissors, so I guess it's.
Your roll didn't go through, Zoros.
Yeah. Still didn't go through. I'm gonna try rolling it in D&D Beyond if it's not working.
I did, I rolled a 16.
Popped up on D&D Beyond as a 16.
It's not popping up for us.
Hold on. Because I'm a nice one. There, I speak, Captain. So you know I'm not lying.
Okay.
I'll take it.
Yeah.
Take it. He wins. So
I guess it's me.
Dan, you're going down.
Yeah.
I'm yelling, Kraken.
Does anyone have any... do we have any scuba gear or anything?
Why would I need scuba gear?
No, not you, just us in general.
I don't know.
Wait, Kreeth, what are you doing on your turn?
Yeah, you haven't done anything.
I was supposed to be shooting a crossbow bolt, but...
You never did.
Remember, there's 3 tentacles. There's still 3 tentacles outside of the water.
Yeah, shoot the one that's outside of the water.
What if you two threw me into its mouth?
You would drown to death,
now,
probably?
Now, I'm pretty sure Zoros can talk to this creature, yes?
Probably.
I can't.
He probably can.
Zoros just has to get down to its face.
Okay, so I guess me and Zoros are both going down there, then.
You know what?
Open your mouth and try and remove the anchor out of your mouth.
Great! Get back over on our ship so we don't shoot you!
Yeah.
Well, you want me to roll to jump over back onto the ship?
Acrobatics.
How far is the ship away, though?
I'm fine.
Oh.
he's good enough.
Yeah. What's up? You do a triple backflip?
3 backflips and a...
Okay. That was very impressive, not gonna lie.
Is there anything else you want to do?
Yeah. Kreeth, you could shoot it with the crossbow.
You guys are gonna go try and knock this thing.
Yeah.
Shooting it, probably hurting it, is not a good idea.
Yeah, probably not.
So, I'm just gonna wait and see what happens.
And all the pirates on the ship are like, "Ah! You! How dare you!" Nor the ghosts on the other ship.
Yeah.
They're mad.
Well, I got off the ship. They can deal with them being mad.
Oh, you could go and get... No, wait. Can he get... Does Pierre have metal on him? Maybe he can, like, levitate Pierre up.
He's not that strong with his powers yet.
Yeah, no, I can't grab him out of the water.
Yeah, he has been within 5 feet for it to make an attraction.
Yeah. Yeah, what can you do, man? You can't go into the water. You don't want to shoot it.
Yeah, that's why I'm saying I'm going to wait, because there's nothing I can do.
Can he hold an action? Can't Kreath hold an action?
Well, he does have the dodge option.
Can you throw me some rope?
Have you guys noticed that the tentacles are not trying to attack your guys' ship?
Yeah.
Actually, I do have rope. Could I throw Girl Bear rope?
Yes, you can do that as your action.
Okay, what do you want me to roll for that?
Hold on to one end, though.
Although, when they try to climb up, they will have to make athletics.
Can he
Tie Pierre to the rope.
Can he pull up Pierre?
Okay, yeah. Give me athletics. Hendrix will help you, so you have advantage.
And Pierre,
you have advantage.
I like to imagine Pierre's missing like a tooth or whatever. He's bleeding.
Pierre's probably fucked up. He got slammed into the boat like basketball style.
Yeah, you threw his face into the boat like 2 times.
Yeah, in a row.
And he couldn't brace himself or anything.
Nope, he was already unconscious because I paralyzed him.
Yeah. Does he get him up there?
Yes, with the athletics. Pierre is back up and safe.
Okay.
Pierre doesn't have a turn.
Yep, he's still unconscious.
It is the Kraken's turn. It's gonna the two tentacles that are in the water are gonna try to swipe at both of you guys. Dexterity saving throws for both of you.
Who's both?
Zoros and Dan.
Okay.
Zoros and Dan.
Dexterity saving.
Dodge it.
Dexterity saving throws to dodge the tentacle from grabbing you. You just need a 15. You both save.
We both got the same score.
Again, you guys are in sync.
Yeah, we're pretty in sync with it.
Let Evangelion sync music.
Yeah.
You hear a loud screaming bubbles coming up from the depth.
Okay, can
what's he saying? Can I understand him?
The three tentacles on the boat start wrapping around the boat, and it's almost like he's pulling himself up.
I can't talk to him.
He's 60 feet from you guys now.
Well, I can't make that.
And the chain from the anchor is going straight to his mouth.
Can I?
Okay.
Can I pull the chain? Command Zora.
You can athletics. You can athletics pull the chain.
Yeah.
But you might hurt the Kraken.
So I'm gonna talk to the Kraken. Let's help you get rid of the anchor in your mouth.
He can't hear you from this far. You have to get closer.
Get closer then.
How close? 30 feet? Are you dashing? Well, it's Dan's turn. It's Dan's turn, so Dan, that would you do.
I guess I will try to use strength to pull the chain, to pull the Kraken up so that he's closer.
Athletics.
Okay. Athletics. Okay.
And each round is 30 seconds.
Okay.
So we've gone to what? 3 rounds? So you've been underwater for 3 minutes?
I came to the surface.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So you restart.
Yeah.
That's a good enough athletics. You pull the chain 20 feet.
Get over here!
Yeah!
Upward.
How close is he now?
And you 40. Hear a loud roar. And a roar of pain.
Okay, he's close enough for you to get, Zoros. And I'm gonna use my other thing just to heal myself.
You use 2d4 damage to him.
Okay. And then I'm just gonna heal myself after that. 1d6 plus 4.
Bonus action heal?
Yeah.
You know what? Since you're a fishman karate, I'll let you heal. Normally you can't heal underwater.
Oh, okay.
No. How are you gonna use a medkit underwater? Or in water?
Well, I'm using the walk it off.
Okay. Yeah. Doesn't that require you to walk it off?
It's just a bonus action. It just says I can heal myself. Fine. Yeah.
So that's your turn?
Yeah, what did I roll?
He just swims in a few circles.
So now he is 40 feet below you, Zoros. It's your turn, Zoros.
Hey,
he's close enough to you now. Yeah, I pulled him up. to 40 feet and you can swim 40 feet.
But let's help you get rid of the anchor out of your mouth.
Persuasion. With disadvantage, because you guys are hurting.
He's very strong, Zoros. Please hurry.
Disadvantage. Ah! A 10 was not good enough.
Mm. You look like food to me. If you like to help, get in my mouth.
Lovely.
Can Zoros try to remove the anchor?
How big is that anchor?
It's very strong, though. Deep. It's lodged deep in his... Like, it's not in his mouth. It's not like a fish hook around his jaw. It's like he swallowed the anchor.
Like, literally in his belly swallow?
Yes.
Can you break the chain?
Well, like, what's agitating him is the anchor.
Yeah, that's true.
In his belly.
I mean, I did tell them that there's treasure and the other captain in there, right?
Yeah, but that's up to Zoros to want to dive into that thing's mouth.
He knows the information, it's just whether or not...
Wait, okay, so even if you're in the belly of a beast that's underwater, would you still be unconscious if you had devil fruit?
Creep?
No, as long as I'm not actually physically touching the water, I'm fine.
You have to be submerged up to chest level in any type of liquid to be unconscious. So as long as he's...
I thought it was just seawater.
No, any liquid. You could bathe in orange juice and you would pass out. But it has to be up to waist. So you can take, like, showers and bath. You couldn't...
If I was to go in the belly, I'm like, supposedly killing with stomach acids.
You'd probably take damage, right? Like, every turn or something. You'd probably be, like, being swallowed.
No, you don't take any damage.
Oh.
He allows you to go inside his mouth.
Okay, then I can go inside his mouth then, if he's allowing me to it. I could try and get rid of...
He opens his mouth. And water, like, sucks you in. And now you are inside. Zoros, this is very big on what you decide to do next. There is the anchor connected to the chain. There is a chest. And there is an intact captain down there, still alive.
Oh, well, let's see.
Someone came to save me.
Just have him grab the chest.
You are so lucky I can speak to the Kraken.
It's been 40 years. Thank God somebody came to save me.
How are you not dead?
What's this guy been eating?
I ate a devil fruit that allowed me to never die.
Just sort of devil fruit.
Wow, that's a pretty busted devil fruit.
What's in the chest?
All my riches. You can have it if you help me.
What are your riches?
Well, you can have it. It's all in there.
What are your riches?
Well, you take it. It's all yours.
That's a vague answer. What is it specifically? Because you see, I have a choice. I can either free you. Grab your riches. Okay, we're the anchor for the Kraken.
You can do both, he says deceptively.
I would go with the anchor.
You no longer have. Listen, you save me, you get the chest, and you free the anchor.
But the thing is, what's...
Remember, you're stronger inside the Kraken because it's underwater.
You could... Couldn't you remove the anchor and have him grab the chest for you and, like, swim out?
The guy is not strong enough.
It's been 40 years. He's probably weak as all
hell.
Yeah,
he's probably an old-ass man.
Yeah, he ages normally. He's an old-ass man, but he can't die.
Hmm.
Wait, he ate a devil fruit, right?
Yeah, he's not touching any liquid. He's, like, on a piece of land that's inside the Kraken.
Anyway, someone has to take him out.
Yeah,
Here's the thing, though. You give me the treasure, tell me what it is specifically. For I know, there could be shoes in there for I know.
Oh, it's a treasure. It's worth a million berries.
A million berries worth it?
So the problem is you have to be specific. What is it? I'm just a vassal.
It's not a million berries.
A million berries is
worth a million berries.
A million berries is like 900.
It's probably another devil fruit.
Okay, but you gotta put this in perspective. A million berries is like $900. Is Zora's gonna potentially die for $900?
Okay, I already chose already. The anchor.
You're gonna let this guy sit down here?
He's an asshole, fuck him!
Grab the chest too!
The ghost will kill me if he does not come out.
He has a +4 to persuasion. He's gonna persuade you 14. You need to make a charisma saving throw higher than 14.
Nope!
He persuaded you to save him and pull the anchor.
Let's go then.
Is he holding onto the chest then, I'm guessing?
No, he has the chest next to him on this little island that's inside the Kraken.
Zoros cannot do three things, Creed.
Yeah, No, I was asking if the guy was holding it.
Well, a high enough of athletics, he can carry the chest and pull the anchor.
How far down is the Kraken?
This dude weighs about 120 pounds.
Yeah.
He's a skinny 70-year-old man.
Okay, Zoros, you got this.
Athletics?
Yeah.
Come on! Athletics.
You need higher than a 14.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
And you have a +1 to your athletics for being underwater.
You got a 15.
Hell yeah. Just what you needed.
So 15, barely. You pick up the chest and you yank the anchor out of his mouth.
Oh! A bellyache. Thank God. Take this decrepit man out.
Will do. Let's go, old man, before I eat you.
Oh. And stop pulling.
One question. You guys aren't going to kill me after you free me, right?
That depends how you penetrate us after that. I mean, after all, I've never had a crippled man before for dinner. You're old and weak and frail.
Okay, so you have the chest, which weighs 300 pounds, so it's heavy as fuck.
Well, Zoros is pretty small.
But when you shake the chest, it feels empty.
They open the chest to see what's inside of it.
It is locked.
Where's the key, old man?
It's on my ship. It's on my ship. I assure you. I have.
If the key's not there, I'm going to kill you. I'm going to eat your eyeballs.
Was the old man this Kraken the whole time?
Yeah. Okay. What happened?
So, yeah, since I can break... Wait, how changed did that lock look, actually?
Why don't you just bring it up to the surface, and then we'll just break it on the ship?
Did Austin DC again?
What?
Austin.
It'll be an athletics of 15 to swim up all the way to the pirate ship.
Okay.
Like, on top. You'll get on top.
No!
Oh, so you only get halfway. You have the captain with you and the chest. The Kraken withdraws all of its tentacles and swims down to the deeps.
Thank you.
Bless you with the Kraken blessing.
Woot woot. I bow gracefully and thank him.
This anchor got way lighter.
You'll learn about what that is later. But you swim... halfway up, Kraken's gone.
Hey, Zoros. Can I let go of the chain?
Yes, you can let go. Ugh.
Okay.
All right. So all of you, what do you want to do? This is one last action. Where do you want to be? You want to be on the pirate ship, or do you want to be on your guys' ship?
Whichever has the chest.
Well, I'm close.
So Groovy.
Yeah.
So everybody in the water, you'll have to make an athletics to get onto the pirate ship.
Uh huh. I'll do the pirate ship, I guess, since I'm closer.
Groby,
whichever one has the chest.
That's Groby, you have disadvantage because you're trying to get back on the pirate ship, the ghost ship.
But I'm in a rage.
Yeah, you get a +1.
Okay, I get on the ship.
So you got 8. Groby is slowly climbing up on the ship, still frightened. Dan just does a flip onto the ship. He sees the chest and the captain. Oh, thank God. More normal people. No offense, Fishman.
What the fuck's with the old man, Zoros?
As he wakes up from being unconscious from the water. Oh, I'm so drained. And all the ghosts are there that Groby can see as he peeks his head up on the edge of the ship. Oh, God.
Yeah, what's with the old man?
With the key there?
The key is right here. And he goes. All the ghost pirates are cheering. They're like, yes, our captain is free. That means we are free.
Is this their captain or whatever, Zoros?
That's your captain. That's your captain.
How are you alive?
All right, devil fruit. Good, oh, sir.
Of course.
40 years. 40 years. Been trapped in that crack.
Yeah, what'd you do to piss it off?
Well, it ate our anchor, killed all my crew. I did bargain with our treasure. It ate the treasure. I jumped in after it was not happy.
Mm.
And that's how I got stuck down there. I did not know that if I jumped into the water, I'd be dead. But I can't die, so...
Oh, cool, so you'd be at the bottom of the ocean. That sounds like hell.
Yeah, thank God the Kraken swallowed me up with the chest.
Yeah, you'd be paralyzed underwater forever. That would have sucked ass.
So he unlocks the key and has, like, everything metal in there is rusted. And, like, as soon as you open it, it just evaporates into dust, all the things in there. Except for a couple pieces of papers and a map.
I'm killing the old man.
And he gives you guys everything that's in there. There's 2 deeds.
Man,
property deeds.
How generous.
2 property deeds. And the map is to a treasure island.
Oh, cool.
That's on the Grand Line.
Mm. Well, I guess we had to go there eventually.
Guaranteed treasure. Guaranteed treasure. This is Jolly Roger's treasure map that I stole from him.
Jolly Roger, huh? Who's Jolly Roger?
He's looking around, and he's like, as the ship starts to sink, and the ghosts of the pirates all start to evaporate and fade away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, can I come with you guys?
Why?
I'm kind of out of a ship and crew here.
What do you have to offer us, old man?
Wisdom. Lots and lots of wisdom, young man.
We already have that old guy right there.
But I'm older, so that means I'm wiser, right?
Not really.
Yeah. Also, we have we have a 1,020-year-old archaeologist, so...
Also, what is your devil fruit power anyways?
I guess he's just immortal.
Is that a power for a devil fruit, or are all devil fruit eaters immortal?
No, they're not. That must just be his fruit.
That's true. That's more of a curse.
No die-die fruit.
Oh.
That's more of a curse than a blessing, honestly.
Yeah, that kind of sucks, especially given
circumstances.
Does that mean you'll just become fucking a vegetable for the rest of eternity?
Yeah, you're eating a banana, but little did you know, you're just signing up for the worst existence in life.
Does that mean your body will turn to dust eventually? Then
I don't know.
How do you still live? Do you like become a ghost?
I didn't think this far ahead. To be fair, I thought I would starve to death a long time ago. Yeah. By the way, do you have any food?
Again, what do you have to offer us, old man? We ain't giving you shit. I mean, thanks for the...
I literally have nothing else.
Thanks for the map for the two bootleg Gold Roger's treasure. I'm sure that will be pretty cool.
The deeds are worth half a million.
What's the property? Where is this? This is just a deed to some building. Who knows where?
it's a deed to royal lands.
Also, we're pirates. Pirates don't give a shit. We would take this regardless.
you could sell it, and it'd be worth more.
We're still taking the shit regardless. I want to know what you have to offer our crew.
Man, I might be dumb, but who would buy land from pirates?
I also can navigate the...
We have, like, two navigators already.
I can help you get through the Grand Line if you need. I've been there before.
Okay, now we're listening.
You play any instruments?
Tell you what.
I do play a mad drum.
Tell you what, we do need a cabin boy, so welcome to the crew.
Cabin boy.
I thought you already had one, but...
No.
No, that's just our training.
His ship is literally sinking as you guys are on it. Just letting you know.
Oh, yeah. Fuck. Yeah, let's head to our ship.
Acrobatics.
Onward to adventure. Acrobatic, huh?
Soros, you failed.
I just land there.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys are all back on your ship?
I'll do a triple front flip.
But to be fair, I am kind of tired from going inside a dragon's mouth.
Yeah.
For his token or whatever, it'd just be an old, decrepit man.
Okay.
Skinny.
Yeah.
No glasses, full white beard.
What's your name, old man? Otherwise, we're just gonna end up calling you old man, like what happened with the kid, so you should tell us now.
What's your name, kid?
My name is Manny D. Monkey.
Manny D. Monkey, huh? So your first name is Monkey, and your last name is Manny?
Monkey Manny.
Okay.
Get that down.
You have a D in your name?
Oh, it's by marriage.
That's just like...
Oh god, my wife!
That's like my mom, dude. She has a name, her name.
God, she's dead, huh?
Who?
Everyone I knew and love is dead.
Yeah, probably.
I didn't.
Yeah, probably everyone you know is dead, yes. Most likely.
Ponder on that. It's been really hard to keep track of time. How long have I actually been in there? I counted 40 years, but I could be wrong.
I don't know. How old was Gold Roger when he was a pirate?
He was a young captain.
How old was he?
Okay.
So, you guys can give me history or insight to figure out how old he is.
Not bad for a flat roll.
It has only been 25 years. She's been counting wrong.
Well, it's only 25, so I'd say you're 70.
I was in my spry, in my peak. I got swallowed by the Kraken.
Not anymore.
So you're like 50 or 60 then. You look horrible for your age.
I feel a lot young. Well, not eating and drinking will do that.
Fair. If you didn't have a fucking immortal fruit, you would be hella fucked.
I'd be dead, you idiot.
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't mean to call you an idiot.
Well, yeah. Someone waterboard him, please.
Asher's pointing a pistol at him.
How's Pierre?
Yeah. Oh, shit, Asher! Where were you?
Oh, I was,
We were looking for you earlier.
I was dealing with some documents.
Oh, okay.
In the captain's quarters.
Why were you in my quarters?
Well, it's the only private place in the entire ship.
You weren't doing anything weird in there, were you? I just cleaned there.
I was just making sure my brother was nowhere near us.
Oh, okay. Okay.
God forbid he find us.
There better not be in any, like, weird shit, though.
Trust me, the weirdest thing about me is the squirrel.
Yeah.
He turns into a squirrel, and then in there, he's like...
You know, you're one of the only serious members of our crew, and you have the most ridiculous power.
Honestly, the power could be beneficial at times.
Yeah, it is.
Creep, as he looked over at Kreeth, and he's like, we should kill this pirate.
The old guy?
You can't kill me.
I mean, we could throw you into the bottom of the ocean, but...
I've tried many times down there.
Look, he says he can navigate the Grand Line. We do need that at some point, and...
We want to go to the Grand Line? Why do we want to go to the Grand Line? Asher says all scared-like.
I mean, that's kind of just the pirate thing to do. You
know
wanna...
the dragons are in the Grand Line, right?
There's a lot of shit in the Grand Line. Yeah. There's the Navy HQ.
My brother.
The emperors are somewhere in the Grand Line. A lot of the warlords are there. Yeah, there's a reason why it's called the Pirate Graveyard, but why not? Yeah, you want us just to sail around the North Blue for fucking ever? Come on, Asher.
Well, I had no idea what you guys planned on doing, so yeah.
Well, I want to become one of the emperors, and August needs to kill one of the dragons. I don't know what Zoro's ambition is.
Any ruins.
Yeah.
Any ruins.
That's probably somewhere. There's probably ruins in the Grand Line. Julie likes finding out about stuff, so she'd probably want to go there. Kreeth?
The captain is quite interesting, him being old.
Yeah, Kreeth wants to kill someone. Maybe they're in the Grand Line, so we got to go there. Eventually, Asher. Don't you have like a 30 million buried bounty or some shit?
He shows you the bounty that you guys all didn't get.
Yeah, what is it?
It's 100 million.
I'm only a little bit devastated, but yeah. So you should be fine with the Grand Line.
Yeah, well, the North Blue is the safest place for me right now.
Well, look,
it's the only blue that my brother hasn't been to.
Well, look, Asher. If when we get there you want to leave, that's up to you.
Like, oh no, I'm with you guys till I die. You saved me from being hung.
Yeah, no, don't worry. We'll just kick your brother's ass. Like, it's whatever.
He's a dragon. He's a dragon. Like, literally, he's a dragon.
Wait, like a celestial dragon? Or like a physical dragon? Like the mythical dragon or the celestial dragon?
Both? Question mark?
Wait, so you're a celestial dragon then?
I wouldn't say I'm a celestial dragon.
Then
he's confused. He doesn't know what that means. He just knows that his
were you born
fruit,
in
brother's
the
devil fruit power is that he can turn into a dragon.
Do you not know what a celestial dragon is then?
He doesn't know about that stuff.
Weird. Okay. That's weird. Your brother can turn into an actual dragon though. That's pretty badass.
Yeah, he got a devil fruit and he gave me one and it turned me into a squirrel. I figured I'd be a dragon like him.
Yeah, seems to be a shit show with what you get, huh?
He just screwed you over deliberately.
Yeah, he might have known what it was.
You don't even want to know the name of my fruit.
The squirrel fruit?
Actually, the nut fruit.
I'm not gonna be laughing in the captain's quarters or anything. Okay.
I can do other things as a squirrel, but right now it's squirrel.
No,
I can make grenades as a squirrel out of acorn.
I mean, that's pretty great, man.
It's actually pretty useful, but it's still funny.
Yes, it's
shut up, Kreeth.
It's pretty funny.
You're a thief and you're stuck to metal.
We're all thieves, man. We're pirates.
You're trying to blow me up, so this is hilarious.
The kid, I'm not a thief.
Not yet. We'll get you there, though, kid.
Toros, you have a Kraken
blessing.
Kraken blessing.
Yeah, whatever that is.
you can either try to learn what that is on your own, or you can ask the old pirate.
Could he ask Julie?
What that is. Julie, wait. Yeah. You all get 600, except for Zoros, who gets 1500.
So, I didn't really do anything besides beat the shit out of Pierre.
Yeah, you still get 600 for that.
Damn,
you think I don't give XP for beating up Pierre?
We're sailing towards the Hammond Islands, right? That's what you said? Okay.
And you guys are there.
We already made it
there. I'm giving you a choice.
Oh, okay.
The top island, Doe Island, would take all day to get there, so it'd be nighttime.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do that one.
What? No, well, let's hear Ray, the thing.
The Ray Island, you would get there first. It's the closest island to you guys. Mm-hmm. May Island would take half day, so it'd be almost night. It would turn nighttime as you go there.
Is there any downfall to going to the one closest to us?
The only downfall
hippies.
Actually, there isn't any downfall, but they're music lovers and they hate dinosaurs, which is the reason why you guys are going to these three islands.
Well, then we should probably go there first. Then we can just walk into the other islands or whatever.
They're all traversable through man-made bridges of stone.
Yeah, I think it'd be better. It would probably be faster than sailing around anyway if we went to the first island and then just walked through where we needed to go.
Okay, Dinophobe Island we go.
Yeah.
The Annex hippies.
I guess set course for Pierre. What was that name of that island again?
Ray Island.
Okay, so Ray Island.
You guys are docking at Wrecker's Reef.
Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. Also,
there are four other towns on this island.
Yeah.
That you can go to.
Okay. Oh, I had a question for Grillbear since he's a shipwright and handyman or whatever. You know that chest of stuff that Kreeth threw into the ocean and broke? Can he fix it or no?
He is more for fixing boats.
Okay.
You need someone who can actually fix that chest.
Okay.
Somebody that, like a blacksmith or
To a town, why don't we go to the blacksmith in a tavern?
Is that the magical chest?
Yeah, the one that had the gold gun and the sword that made you big that Kreeth threw into the ocean. But yeah.
Sword that made you big.
Yeah, remember Pierre used it or whatever? It like increased your strength or whatever.
The items inside the chest would be damaged.
Okay, yeah.
This is just a normal chest.
Yeah.
I thought the one that could talk was the one that got thrown into the ocean.
I think it was, wasn't it? I don't remember. But I know there was items in it that got damaged.
Yeah, I have to watch the episode again, which I don't think you have it up yet. But anyways, You guys reach the port of Reefers Bay. Reefers. Wrecker's Reef.
Okay. Okay. Nice. Okay, August.
And as soon as you get there,
mm-hmm.
you are welcome to the town.
Oh, that's interesting. So we just
weird.
We just walk onto the island and everyone's like, "Hey, pirates!"
You haven't walked on the island. As your boat sails in, you are welcome. They're like, "Oh, hunters and contestants, all welcome."
Are they cheering for pirates? Are we on?
Well,
they
don't care what your flag is. They don't care what your flag is.
Yeah, but we'd probably still be weirded out by it.
As you see docked on the bay, you see multiple different types of pirate flags, bounty hunter flags, even marine flags.
Great marines. Ugh.
If no one is on any of these ships, I'm stealing everything.
There are people on these ships.
I don't want to get into a three-way war between pirates, bounty hunters, and marines if we can help that, Kreeth.
And dinosaurs.
Yeah.
You see that the guards are well equipped.
All
right. So before I switch over to the island map, is there anything on the boat you guys want to do?
We should probably gather any supplies and whatnot, right?
Is this really the dinosaur maps? The kid exclaims.
It sure is. You got your pistol and sword ready, kid?
Oh, we're going to be fighting dinosaurs, right?
We might be.
Oh, man.
Unless you want to come with me and save some dinosaurs. Get a dinosaur as a friend.
Julia knows some of the history of this map, of this these islands.
Yeah.
And she does not recall...
people, right?
Them being separated by different tribes of people. Before when humans lived here, it was mostly love for the dinosaurs, so she's... concerned in the thousand years that now they want to kill them.
Yeah, makes sense. Let's see. We should gather some cooking supplies in case we find a dinosaur we want to eat, some medical supplies, and we should decide who's going onto the island and who's staying on the ship. Let's see.
Four people should be able to watch this dip, yeah. Briggs says.
Let's see.
Oh, wait, did you make tokens for them? For Briggs?
I did, yes. I can send you it.
Yeah, go ahead and send me that. If you have him staying on the ship, then
Yeah.
You don't need to send me the token now.
Yeah, but I have him staying on the ship. I don't know how much he can help. okay, so it'll be me, Kreeth, Grillbear, Zoros, August, the kid needs to get some experience. Julie should probably come with us as well, since she's the smartest of us. And Hendrix, just in case.
Gonna leave Asher, Pierre, and Lightning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially Pierre's.
Yeah, I don't know how much Pierre can help fight a dinosaur. Plus, he was kind of saying weird stuff last time, so I don't know. I don't want to deal with him right now.
And then there's the old man.
You know what? Maybe the squirrel guy should come with us as well.
He might. Joel and Briggs say, "Well, all of you could go. We can watch the ship."
Yeah, but
and as you guys port, if you guys are ready to port right now.
You know what?
Guards will protect your ship.
Yeah, let's have Asher and
Danny Lightning.
D Lightning come with us as well.
Lightning strikes twice.
Yeah.
You're gonna leave me alone with the guards. Great, great conversation, people.
What, you don't like Briggs and Joel?
he forcibly makes himself go with you guys. Please don't leave me with them.
Okay, but you might be used as dinosaur bait if you come with us.
Yeah, I'd honestly die by dinosaurs than stay with it.
Why?
Yeah, why?
I think he just likes us.
They're not conversation people. They don't talk.
So you would rather die than have a bad conversation with someone?
Hey, I don't necessarily have to go fight the dinosaurs. You can just leave me at this town. They like music. They like talking to people. They like people. We're welcome here.
Okay, fine, Pierre.
Thing we're gonna do is leave you by yourself.
Yeah, Pierre, you're with me.
Fuck it, let's take him. I don't want to keep having this conversation.
I agree.
Let's just say there's more harm I could do by myself than.
How does that make us want to take you, Pierre?
No, if he's by himself, he's going to get into trouble and steal a bunch of shit, like I would.
Okay, fine.
Fair point.
Together.
Maybe we should just tie him up then.
No, it's fine. We'll just take him. We need probably bait anyways.
Yeah, maybe we should just tie him up still.
Pierre's pretty fast.
All the North Blue, actually. I have records set on my island.
You
do we grab any money?
You do? Why do? Well, yeah, we probably took some money. Probably not a ton of it. I don't know. You're the treasury guy, pretty much. How much did we take? You're the one hoarding the money.
Well, how much would we take, to be absolutely honest? Like, in currency of berries, like, what is 50,000 again?
50,000 is like, 1 million is about $9,000. So 50,000 would probably be like $500.
Well, let's take 50,000 with us to make sure we can get some stuff.
Okay.
Big spenders. Expensive. Big spenders. Nice. I like it.
Yeah.
These guys like music, so I think I found my place to start my rock.
Yeah. Hopefully Azazel doesn't show up, though. He might still be looking for it.
Ah, Azazel won't show up. He's much of a...
Well, I don't think Azazel himself will show up.
My French, but you idiot.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. He probably will send someone else to do his dirty work. He'll probably send the fucking rock guy or the big hulking guy or the fucking guy that shoots fire.
Maybe he's in league with the dinosaurs.
He's out there.
Or someone else that...
I don't like any of those guys.
He might send someone we don't know, like how he sent you to kill us.
Do I look like an assassin?
No, not now. But you were... He was using you. You even admitted that.
And I'm not in contact with him. Since you have my,
I know. I'm not saying you are. I'm saying he might send someone like you.
He might send me to die.
Does he have a vendetta against you?
Oh. Besides, he hates that I'm a screw off and like to have fun.
Well, he definitely has one against me. So if he thinks we're alive, he's probably sending someone after us.
So you guys notice D-Lighten go running off port immediately without you guys.
Is he going? What the fuck? D-Lightning, where the fuck are you going?
Can I
haven't done anything in a while. Give me some time.
You going to the brothel or something?
He looks back at you guys. He's like, I actually don't know where I'm going.
Please
help me, guys. Please help me, guys. I don't know where I'm going.
Well, then you should probably stay with us, man.
Because I'm going to go with Pierre to the tavern. so D-Lightning can join us.
Yeah, okay.
Me and the kid are gonna go hunt dinosaurs.
There are two taverns in Wrecker's Reef.
Mm.
One of them is the musical tavern. The other one is the rundown All Bandits Welcome tavern.
Pierre, D-Lightning, Creep, go to the Bandits one.
Bandit Hideout.
Yeah, go there. Hendrix, you should probably go to the music one. Who do you want to take with you, Hendrix?
By myself, I need a band.
Okay, well...
At least two other people should be enough.
Let me take August and Squirrel Guy.
Yeah, take August and Squirrel Man with you. August, you're in charge, okay?
I'll take the bear, too. He knows his way around the banjo.
Okay.
What?
Grill Bear,
you sold me there. You're coming with, too, kid.
All right, yeah, the kid will go with him, too.
Okay,
are you by yourself, or are you just with,
What?
Julie. Are you with Julie? Where are you?
It's me, Julie, Zoros, and who the hell else is there?
That's it. That's just the three of you.
Okay, the three of us.
Oh.
We should probably...
So if you're going with... If you're going with Hendrix, put yourself over by Hendrix. If you're going with D-Lightning, put yourself with D-Lightning.
Wait, where is our tokens? I don't... Oh there we are. Okay. Okay, so it's me, Zoros, and Julie. We'll go ask around the general village people.
Hey, you guys should definitely...
Zoros, this is the first time you don't have to use the monkey sword.
Yeah.
Yes!
Because you see other fish people walking around.
Yeah, they probably don't give a shit. It's like that pirate... village that was in Pirates of the Caribbean, pretty much, right?
Oh, it's more of they're accepting everyone to kill the dinosaurs.
Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, sweet.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So me, Julie, and Zoros will just go ask around town. You guys take the bar, and we'll meet back in the center of town, I guess, when we figure out what's going on.
So, as of right now, I have... Hendrix, Groby, and who else with him?
The kid and kid August.
August. And the squirrel guy, right?
Yeah.
The squirrel guy is like, I'm not going with him. Please don't make me go with him.
Okay, well, you want to come with us to the bandit tavern?
Or you can come with us to ask with people.
Yeah, I'll stay with you guys. You guys seem to be on a more political manner.
Yeah, I'm going with Pierre to go steal stuff, so ignore us.
And yeah, Pierre and Kreeth as a combination is a bad combination.
Yeah, they got D-Lightning, though.
All right, we're going to start off with Pierre and D-Lightning.
So we're going to lose a second one?
Pierre and D-Lightning go to...
Don't get D-Lightning killed, Kreeth.
Bandits Keep, and they walk in there. There's candle lit. That is the only light you have in here. It is dim as all heck. All the patrons ignore you as you walk in.
You can speak Thief's Cant though, right? Can't you, Kreeth?
Yeah, I can.
So you can probably communicate with them.
So can Pierre, but D-Lightning cannot.
Yeah.
D-Lightning walks in there. I'll give anyone a drink. If they buy me one that's big. The biggest man in the bar stands up.
Saying you can outdrink me, pretty boy.
You got this, D-Lightning. Go for it.
Pretty boy.
I don't think I can outdrink you. And he looks at him with lightning in his eyes. I know.
Yes.
Hell yeah.
The big man takes off all his gold that he's wearing jewelry and slams it on the table. I bet all of this, you and your two little gronies can't drink me under the table.
So he's just decked out in gold?
Did he just call me a grony?
Yeah, that's what he said.
D-Lightning steps in and puts... He sees that you are offended by being called a grony. These two...
How's a grony?
These two are the greatest thieves in all of the North Blue. And I think they can outdrink you, despite their small stature. My name isn't D-Light.
How tall is D-Lightning?
And winks. He is 6 foot.
So he's the same height as Kreeth, so that makes no sense.
This man that's standing up next to you is like 7'5".
Yeah. Pierre's small,
buff
though.
Buff as all heck. He's got scars all over him. Wearing like a... Looks to be like a dinosaur robe.
Pierre's barely taller than Zoros. He's like 5'3", right?
Wearing like a velociraptor skin.
Oh, sweet.
You look new, so I'll give you a warm-up round. First, I want to see if those two can handle. And he pulls out some Allosaurus ale. Everything here is dinosaur-themed.
You gotta get some Bronto burgers, Kreeth.
if you drink this Allosaurus ale and make it, then the bet goes on. If it doesn't, then obviously you owe me more.
What do I need to roll then?
Kreef loves booze.
Constitution, a constitution saving throw of 15.
It's in your backstory, Kreef. You love booze.
Pierre has a negative one.
What the fuck? Why did my headphones get out?
Pierre drinks it and immediately passes out.
Oh, okay.
I rolled a nat 20.
Kreef drinks it and he's like, I'm down. Give me it. D-Lightning with a plus 2 to con. I like the attitude, Kreef. He drinks it and he's drunk. Strong man with plus 6 con drinks it. A problem.
Okay, it's Kreef and fucking the big
D-Lightning is still standing up though. So yeah. He is going, but he is drunk. He has the con modifiers to being drunk.
I like to imagine
ups your strength, but lowers your dexterity and charisma.
Okay. Alright, so now what's going on?
Well, he takes two pitchers and drinks them in front of you. D-Lightning's like, oh no. He has a plus 6. He passes both of them.
Jesus!
Your turn, little man.
He's talking to Kreef.
Alright.
Cheat him.
Oh, fuck.
D-Lightning slaps you on the back. Better. You have another constitution saving throw.
You could also use your inspiration point if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Kreef, you are now drunk. D-Lightning looks at you like, the fuck? If I drink one more, I'm done for. But he passes it. He sluggishly gets it down. That's the best you got. You guys are both drunk now. It's like, and he grabs 3 pints.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, God.
You should have put some...
He's hardcore.
You should have put alchemist fire in his drink or some shit.
Well, he killed one.
So he, at 20 is one of them.
Yeah.
And he drinks it like he didn't even drink it. But one of them spills down his mouth. He's like, God damn it. You guys have all lost one.
Okay, Kreef.
Once you lose two, you're done. You're like Pierre.
You got this, man. Eye of the tiger.
I will not give you any more help from D-Lightning. D-Lightning takes a drink. Passes. But now that you are drunk, you'll need a 16 to pass.
16.
Kreef, you got this.
Come on. Oh! I didn't hear no
fucking bell.
Yeah, I didn't hear no bell.
So you guys have started to create a crowd now.
Come on.
Man.
One of the crowd members goes, these guys are supposed to be dinosaur hunters.
Get that. Think about the gold jewelry he's wearing, dude.
Nat 20s. Again. Drinks both of them. No problem. Kreef and Dan Lightning.
I will not lose.
He loses.
I will not.
Well, too soon.
Looks like it's all on you, little man. All this jewelry.
We'll all right, just I got take a question.
We'll just take what's on you if you pass out.
Adrian!
Take what's on me?
You can't let him steal your shit.
If you pass out, they're just gonna take your belongings.
You have the inspiration point if you fail.
Yeah, I might need to use that. We'll see.
Nope.
Oh, you pass! So if he fails or doesn't get a nat 20, you win, Kreef.
Yeah, come on.
And he slimmed down to just one pint. Failed! He passes out, and all the gold jewelry is yours. D-Lightning gets back up on the table. I knew he could do it. No doubts.
Kreef is going to be decked out like a rapper, dude. He's going to have...
Kreef, you are drunk, though. You are drunk.
All right, I am drunk.
So that will last total of hours.
What's the side effect?
Your con modifier. It's a up 1 in strength and minus 1 in dex, and
it's just not too bad.
So your con modifier
is a plus 3.
It's a plus 2. So 3 hours.
Damn.
3 hours are taken off of how much you would actually be drunk.
So how long is that?
So normally it's based on your weight.
Kreef weighs 180, I think, right?
And you only failed one drunk? Two.
Two, technically, because D-Lightning helped me on one.
Okay, yeah. So you failed one. So one would be normally 3 hours, but you took away 3 hours, so you will be drunk for 1 hour.
Nice.
Is there a way to speed that process up?
What, like so coffee?
Quit drinking? Yeah. Quit drinking?
Yeah. It's not...
The patrons all... They're like, hey, so, are you into the dinosaur tournament too?
Sure, you're not gonna ask them about that?
You know the rules?
Nope.
Perfect. You'll be willing to join my team then?
Nope.
You already have a team.
Well, your two members over there don't look like they're hunting dinosaurs anytime soon. at least for a couple of hours.
Well, I'm not going hunting anytime soon.
It's a good thing you have like 8 people back.
There are no rules once you leave this island.
Okay.
Meanwhile,
is there anything else going on in this tavern before we run away?
Are you where?
Well, you would have to help D-Lightning and Pierre get away.
I gotta know, are you wearing the gold jewelry, Kreef?
Yes. I'm wearing the gold jewelry with this teeth necklace.
This too. Is about 50 pounds of gold jewelry. Like rings, necklaces, he even has like a crown.
Yeah.
Did it just stick to him like all over?
He's technically the dinosaur.
Gold isn't magnetic.
Yeah, no, but that guy was completely passed out, right?
And he's out now.
Yeah.
Can I just like steal everything, including his clothes too?
Why his clothes?
Give me a sleight of hand.
Real Bear might be able to wear the pants, I guess.
no one here cares. If you weren't gonna do it, we were.
And you just have a pair. You have a pair of giant pants on your shoulder.
Do you have a say on your friends over there?
I would take
that. You can steal Pierre's pants.
No, don't let him steal Pierre's pants.
there are certain rules here.
We would have to go get him new pants then.
Once you leave this tavern, I wouldn't steal anything or kill anybody.
Wait, so I can kill this guy too, right?
Yes, go ahead. They're not gonna kill him, just because we'd have to bury the body then.
Yeah, Kreef, what the fuck?
I'll toss in a gold ring for you.
Why do you want him to kill the fucking guy, Kreef?
I just want to kill him. Why not?
I mean, give us one of those gold chains, we'll kill him and bury the body for you.
I'll give him a gold chain.
And he points out the window and there's like a bunch of graves for all the people that have been killed in this tavern.
Yeah, I'll give him one of the gold chains.
Give me,
You could have the guy. You could have
perception to make sure you don't give him the most valuable gold chain.
Yeah.
Give him a random one.
That's fine.
You're kind of drunk too, so you're just like, I don't care.
You're like, I don't give a shit. I probably have like 2 million
It's
berries.
Better that you don't know which ones are valuable right now, huh?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
If you gave him a valuable one, you might have to kill another person.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I might just, you know, I am in a killing tavern. I could kill everybody, but I'm
yeah, good luck with that.
And another guy just stabbed this guy to death. Like,
damn,
repeatedly
right.
In the chest and the neck.
I like this guy.
Then, wow, what the fuck, Kreef?
Strip him of his stuff and throw it on the table. Then they drag his body out back. And the bartender's like, he puts a tally down and you see 372.
Yeah.
73 now.
I like to imagine he has a whiteboard that says days since someone died and then he just erases it.
No, these are people that have been killed.
Yeah.
All right. So D-Lightning,
he goes to the side. He goes to the side and he goes to the side. People have lost the drinking game. And he points 7 up there.
Oops.
You didn't have to kill that man.
are you guys done drinking?
Yeah, for now. I need to leave with D-Lightning because he's barely conscious and Pierre's an idiot.
Yeah, I'd have
I
to.
I might want a shot of your strongest drink.
Who said that?
D-Lightning raises his hand. Pierre is out. He is out and snoozing and snoring.
You'll have to carry him if he passes out, so I would just be like, get out of here. You already got to carry Pierre with you.
Do you want to stop him? Do you want to stop him? No, Pierre's light. You can carry him.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll let him drink because he hasn't had a chance to enjoy himself, but if he passes out, I'll carry
him. And
he could also die if he passes out.
D-Lightning starts crying as he's given the shot. This is for you, D-Lightning. It's the drink.
Hey.
Passes it. He's like, all right, where are we going now? Come on, let's...
Can woo. I give him a shoulder and we get out of here now?
Yeah, are you just heading to the center of town where we said we'd meet up?
Yeah.
Well, that's not very down. Far. It's right here. Meanwhile, I can't wait to rock the faces off. I can't wait to rock the faces off. Will you shut up? August screams from the back.
I don't know, it was kind of catchy.
The kid looks at you guys like, wait, so am I in a band now or what?
Think we're a band, yeah, buddy?
It's like, yeah, we are, kid, and you're the drummer. Pulls out a small drum set, and my little drummer boy makes me proud. August, you can be the stagehand. Hell no. And he like starts walking away. Wait.
August,
you have to be the stage man.
I put August in charge and he just walks away.
Give me a perception check as you're flooded with symphonic noises all playing at the same time.
Would you say a wisdom check?
Perception.
perception check.
Perception.
So the kid, August, and Grill Bear have to make a perception check? Does yes. Hendrix?
Oh, not Hendrix. He's already aware of this.
Whose role was August
that? doesn't. That was the kid. Grillby, go ahead and make your perception check.
Okay, one moment.
You just roll perception.
Yeah, I was just looking for it.
It's underneath nature. Okay, August, you got this, man.
August doesn't care. He's not trying to listen. He's like, why'd I agree to go this way?
Yeah.
Should have gone to come drinking with us.
Yeah, it probably would have fit him a lot better. He's kind of a fish out of water in that he is like a former street thug.
Bear.
Yeah, he's the angsty one in the bear.
Yeah.
You kind of feel nervous about this. You get a minus one to your charisma.
You have pretty good charisma though, don't you?
You feel nervous about hearing this well-played music being played. You hear that, guys? That's the sound of people that are not as good as a rock star as me being playing music right now. Yeah.
It's pretty good though, man.
The kid is like, I don't know, I kind of just hear noises. And the rock star's like, noises? You just hear noises?
The rock stars are like that? Or Hendrix? Oh, okay. You said the rock stars, so I was like, who?
a group of contestants are forming up around you guys. Oh, so you guys signed up? What's your band name? Hendrix steps in front. Hendrix and the...
Hendrix?
Hendrix and the...
Can I roll a persuasion to convince everybody that it's the Hamburglers?
Okay, but for a persuasion... you got a minus one. Oh, we can't name ourselves that. What the hell? we are Hendrix and the bear group and the bears. And he looks at the kid and he's like, he turns into a bear. August is like, yep, I'm done. I'm leaving.
Yep, I'm done.
wait. Is like a bear. Strong, like tough, like one. Then he is actually a bear, as you can tell. Yes, he is a bear. I love it. I love every bit of it. Like, come on, we'll sign you up. Thank God that worked. I wasn't sure that would be our name, but I just thought of it on the spot. Whispers to Groovy.
I thought it should have been Hendrick and the Hamburgers.
Why?
All right. There's just some things we have to sign across. Just some things on the dotted line. Hendrick takes the paper and reads it over. It says, what's our affiliation? Should we put pirates or marines? What should we put?
Party.
That's not one of the options.
Rock and roll.
Just say other. Should we go with other? I like other.
Cross other out and put rock.
Ah, damn it. I couldn't have gotten one of the smart ones.
Give them the paper and say I need a third option.
I can do something.
It says bounty hunter / dinosaur hunter, marines, pirates, other.
You would probably be pirates or other, would be my guess.
And under this is the sexual orientation of the band. I want to assume that even fucking needed. That's not relevant, but I'm just going to say everything. Right? We're good with that?
Rock and roll.
August is like, I am not. I'm so not. So now you're entertained. Our name doesn't matter. I'm just going to
use fake one.
He puts, obviously, rock star.
Pierre.
That's his name. He puts bear guy. He puts kid. And then he puts strong guy with sword.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, we can get you scheduled in here. One thing is, in order to get in, you gotta compete with somebody. I'm sure you want to do that, right? Most definitely.
I guess. I don't know what's going on.
We're ready right now. We're ready right now. And he gets everybody their equipment. Song goes out to all the patrons of the tournament. Yeah. And he starts playing a little song.
I started accompanying his banjo.
Down. These dinosaurs don't even know. Oh, that's not Hendrix. These dinosaurs don't even know what's about to hit them. As I rock them back to the Stone Ages, yeah. Yeah, gonna rock these dinosaurs to that island where they belong. And the kid's like, all right, here's what I got.
Shigadigdigdig.
The winner takes all. It's the thrill of one more kill. The last one to fall. We'll never sacrifice the will. Don't ever look back. The world closing in. Beyond the attack. With your
the fuck, dude? Really
And I'm not there right now.
The crowd is like clapping.
I can imagine Hendrix kind of giving him like the stink eye. Like, what the fuck?
August is like snapping his fingers. He didn't want to take an instrument.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, August just starts dancing. He just starts dancing. He just he like starts doing like the Thriller, like he's a dinosaur. And then Hendrix like slaps him really hard, and he's like, "Yeah, gonna rock them, gonna knock them down. Yeah, we're gonna rock them, gonna knock them
down."
What
is going on?
And August gets really mad and then slaps Hendrix. "Yeah, gonna rock them, gonna knock them down. That hurt. Yeah, gonna rock them, gonna." You guys. Your group, give me a perception check. See if you can hear this.
Alright, sure.
Our group?
Yep.
Perception? Sure.
Okay.
And... Nope, Zoros can't hear it. Dan can't hear it. Julia.
Ow.
And Asher. Asher's not listening for it, but Julia...
Also can't hear it.
Doesn't hear it. Nope, they don't hear anything as you guys travel to...
I'll say
the mayor's office? Or where were you going?
Yeah, okay. Julie, where do you think would be the best part to
start? You gotta imagine this is all happening at the same time.
Yeah. Should we, like, go try to find, like, the leader of this village or something?
I would assume so. If we're signing up for the tournament, that would be the best way to do that. Or... I say we get some information from people downtown.
Hmm.
The square.
Asher, can you go talk to the mayor while we go and talk to people downtown?
You do know I'm, like, wanted by the government, right?
Yeah, we're all wanted by the government, Asher.
I'm like, really wanted by the government, though, so
don't
I
think
don't
anyone here cares, Asher. No one here gives a shit.
Political intrigue.
I can wrap bandages around your face if you want.
I think their dinophobia is more important than us being wanted.
Asher turns into a squirrel. How about this?
Okay.
And I just sit on your side and whisper into your ear what to say.
Okay.
Giving you advantage on diplomatic checks.
Okay, I guess Julie would probably be the best with talking to the mayor, so I guess...
Well, I am 1,000 years out of time. And out of touch, so...
Yeah, but I don't think me and Zoras are the best at diplomatic stuff. I mean, I can go if you guys want.
You see a parade, like, going towards the music festival. And you see a really flamboyant mayor just stick his eyes towards your direction.
Mm. That guy...
Yeah. He like slithers over to you guys.
Is he a snake?
Yes. Yes.
Can I help you with something?
Who are you?
You definitely will be helpful. Still wearing marine stuff, but obviously not getting off a marine ship, so not a marine. And a squirrel. Very cute. Very cute. Yes.
Okay.
You guys are for the tournament? Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, you are. Julia, puts up her glasses. She's like,
"Are you the mayor?"
"Oh, why, yes, I am the mayor. There is a sign-up fee of 100 berries."
"Of 100 berries?"
"Not a problem." "Yeah, I hope that's not a problem. You'll be rewarded, greatly rewarded, if you finish all the tasks."
"Yeah, sure. Tournament. We have 100 berries. That's like a dollar."
Julia's like, "So what's the catch? What are we here for? You can't possibly just want to kill dinosaurs." "Ah, perceptive one. Yes. We are not actually trying to extinct the dinosaurs. More or less. Yeah. We're more or less trying to move them off our island. You see, Ray Island is a peaceful island, and we welcome everyone, especially fish folk like you and ex-marines, I'm guessing." "Yes." "Mm-hmm.
I really gotta find a new outfit."
"And the fact that you have a squirrel as your mascot is just amazing."
"Our mascot? Yes, our mascot, of course."
Deception.
Deception.
He has a plus 5 to charisma saving throws. You just gotta be a 10. Ooh, you lie to him. Ah, I will call you the Squirrel Gang for now, until you change your name for the tournament.
You've
paid 100 berries.
Well, we do have a name, and it's definitely not the Squirrel Gang. I don't know if you've heard of
it. It probably wouldn't be good to go back on a lie. You don't want a disadvantage in the tournament.
We definitely can't go by the fucking Squirrel Gang.
I'm not saying we go as a Squirrel Gang. Just you already lied and said you.
I just said you were a mascot.
Deadly Sins.
Yeah, his name is Sins because we're the seven deadly sins. He's our mascot.
Ah, okay, yes, that makes sense. I love it. Yes, Sins, and he like pets him on the head, and Asher gets all mad, like, oh, fucking pet me.
Just chill out, okay?
One minor problem. Once you leave this island, if it happens, it happens. My guards don't see what they don't know. It's not a problem for me, I guess. But if you so happen to run into anybody that wants you dead, it's fair game. They will kill you.
Oh, so you mean there's no laws here, is what you're getting at?
Any points down the road to the right of you guys. So if you look at the map this way.
Okay.
He shows, and he's like, yes, 5 or 6 pirates were killed in an instant by some stone warrior of some kind wearing marine garb.
That sounds oddly familiar. Doesn't it sound very familiar, Zora?
Too familiar.
I assume he had some kind of fruit powers, but...
God damn it! More fruit powers!
I don't want to be a assumer.
Okay, yeah, so can we just sign up for the tournament then? Here's your 100 berries.
Yes, just go sign in with the signer upper guy. I don't know his name, I don't know a lot of people's names here. But, yeah, so if you are so intrigued to join this tournament with your lives, there'll be a couple tasks that you'll have to sign off on.
How many people can be a part of a team?
7.
Okay.
And one beneficiary member.
What does that mean?
Member will not be included in the 7.
Okay, what does that mean, though?
We got the money.
Someone that goes with you that cannot participate in fighting.
Oh, so like a manager?
Any of the tasks.
Okay.
Yes, of sorts. And the benefactor, when you leave this island, will have to stay here. In case you decide to not kill dinosaurs.
Okay, and that guy's name is Pierre.
Okay, they will be the spokesperson for your party.
Okay.
No problem. So if anything happens to you, it happens to them in tenfold. Yes.
Okay, sounds good. Only if you promise.
Okay, well then fine. I'll lead you straight to that. Meanwhile, at the music festival, the faces have rocked off, and their socks have been completely knocked off. Yes, you are in! You are in! And the kid is like, wow, I'm actually pretty good at this.
Yeah. Does he get a level in being a bard now?
Like, dang, kid, that was impressive.
Are they just walking out towards the center of town then?
No, they are in the music festival now. Alright. You guys will be playing on main stage in the square. You'll be facing up against the dirty flute players.
That don't sound right.
Grubber said that. That don't sound right.
Dirty flute players. God.
Yeah, the dirty flute players.
Definitely.
So, you guys are all at the center of town now?
Yeah.
So you guys see marines, bounty hunters, pirates, a galore around the center. And they're all set up in their teams.
Can I tell if there's any high-ranking marines?
There are no high-ranking marines. There is a sergeant.
Okay, we don't got too much to worry about on the marine front.
A sergeant sees you, Dan.
Uh-huh.
And smiles. Oh, fuck yeah. And he goes straight to you.
Hello?
Gives you a handshake.
Hi. How's it going, Sergeant?
Remember me? don't remember me?
Sorry, my memory's really bad. My memory's a
Dante Kaboom. Dante Kaboom.
Oh!
We used to hate Azazel together.
Oh! Yeah! Shit!
Yeah, we were in the training academy.
Yeah!
You went to be a medic. You went to be a medic, and I went to be...
You're a sergeant now? Pirate.
Well, yeah. Under show. You remember that guy?
Yeah, unfortunately, yeah.
Yeah, you guys got a bounty, but I'm not here to collect your bounty. Don't worry about that.
Okay. That's good.
We're here for the tournament.
Nice.
Beware though. We get off this island, we might have to tussle.
Show here?
Oh yeah, he's in Ray Island right now. He already left with a couple of Marines.
Mm.
Yeah, nice. They're looking for those devil fruit users that aren't Marines or working for the government. So yeah, watch out for that. Did you guys got any of those? I know you don't got any, cause you know you.
It was against Marine regulation, and you know that.
Well, yeah, but I don't know. Those devil fruits are pretty awesome, man.
Do you have one?
Not when you're. Well, that'll be a surprise. I mean, they don't call me Kaboom for nothing.
So, can you blow stuff up?
Yeah.
That's very convenient. You got a fruit that matches your name. I gotta say, that's pretty crazy.
they call me the Kaboom Pirate. A Marine, sorry.
Okay.
I've been dealing with pirates and bounty hunters all day, and they don't like me because I'm a Marine.
Yeah.
But here, we're all equal. We're all equal here.
Yeah. Though they...
Joe wouldn't agree, but...
They still seem to distrust because people are still giving me weird looks.
Ah, no. You should have got a warm welcome here. Mm. They love anybody that's willing to join the tournament.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, you guys are joining, right? He looks at the three that are with you. Well, two with you, because there's a squirrel on your shoulder.
Yeah, we might be, yes. I guess you'll have to find out, huh?
Ah, you guys are here for the tournament. What else would you be in the Hammond Islands for? The
dinosaurs?
Mayor comes up behind you guys. The mayor, obviously, for the warm welcome and the treasures that come with it. And I do mean they come.
Zorus, did you see that guy sneak up on us? What? How the fuck?
Yes, I.
Does he have a double?
I'm the one who named these islands.
Hammond, are you Hammond?
Yes, I am Mayor Hammond. Welcome to my islands.
Hmm. What was this called before you were the mayor?
Ah, that's not important. And
okay.
Julia, like, is like really mad right now, and she's like, "I don't want to strike his ego. Don't strike his ego."
Well, it's nice to see you, Dante. Hopefully we'll see you in the tournament, I guess.
Oh, actually, hopefully you don't see me, because if we get out of this reefer and Joe gave me orders to kill anybody with a devil fruit that's not a Marine, I'm looking at the girl over there. It looks like she could have a devil fruit.
Dante, you know me, right? If you attack a girl, I'll...
First, think later. Yeah, that's always been your MO.
Yeah, I'll kill you.
So I'm curious, does he see my drunk ass just, like, getting magnetized to stuff right now?
No. You have been staying 5 feet away from any metal.
Look, okay, Dante, out of respect of our friendship, I don't want to fight you, and I don't want to cause problems, but fair warning, if you mess with my crew, I'm gonna have to kill you.
Oh, don't worry. I'm not gonna go after your crew, single them out. It's just if you get in the way of one of our tasks, then we have to kill you to complete that task. If you have the same task as us, only one person can complete the task.
What's your task?
With one team. Well, I'm not gonna tell you what our tasks are. That's stupid. The competition, you idiot.
Okay.
Have you even got your task yet?
No,
the mayor slids in between.
We just signed up.
Well, there shouldn't be any task information going on between teams. That would be cheating. We wouldn't want to do that now, would we?
Yeah, no.
Oh, no, Mayor Hammond, I wasn't going to share information or anything. I just wanted to win the competition with my buddy here.
Hey, Creef, when'd you get into town?
Dividing is the best. I'm running.
Hey, Kreath, can you come here a second?
He's drunk.
I'm like half drunk, bud. What do you want?
Pierre is.
You think you can pickpocket Dante and see what tasks he has?
He has metal on him. So that would give you a disadvantage on sleight of hand.
Well, can I roll stealth first to get an advantage?
No, Dante knows of your presence.
Okay, well.
Hmm.
I'll try.
Oh.
Yeah, I just stuck right to the metal sword.
Dante looks at you and he's like, oh, you're touching my sword.
Yeah, he has a devil fruit power. Don't mind him.
I can't control it either, I apologize.
He looks at you and takes your hand off the sword easily.
Okay.
doesn't have to give any effort or thought to it. That doesn't surprise you.
Weird.
No.
Well, Dan, it's nice seeing you again, man.
Can I do a perception on him to see if there's anything different about him?
Yeah, go ahead.
Let's see if I can notice any weird thing about him. That's persuasion. Where's perception? Oh, perception. Okay. So probably not.
You do notice that his clothes are a little burnt.
Okay. Well, hopefully we don't run into Sho if he's on that island, because he's probably here for us, or at least wouldn't hesitate to bring us back to Azazel if he finds us, so.
Yeah, he'll definitely bring you back to Azazel, except for this guy over here.
Who?
And he's looking at Kreath.
Hmm.
He'll probably die. I'm not gonna lie.
So, is Azazel still after us, by the way, do you know?
He doesn't really share information like that with me.
Mm. Yeah, makes sense. Okay, well...
That'd be a question for Sho.
Yeah.
You know Azazel's a captain now, right?
He's a captain now? Did he get promoted?
Yeah. He got promoted after that one captain was murdered. You guys, apparently.
Yeah. Do you really think we murdered that captain, Dante?
Well, I don't think you murdered the captain. And he looks at Kreath and he's like, but your friends are not the best alibi.
Hmm. Well, it was nice seeing you. Hopefully we don't meet again.
Well, we probably will.
Yeah,
he's
we
right.
probably
he will. Most likely.
Well, tell Sho hi for me, I guess.
I probably won't tell Sho that I met you.
Yeah.
It was good seeing you, man. And he, like, gives you another, you know, that meme high five where you guys both, like, flex and high five each other. And you notice, like, fire goes off his tips, off his hands. It doesn't burn you, but you see fire go off his hands.
Yeah. Okay. Well, yeah, he has some sort of combustion devil fruit. Probably an explosion would be my guess.
The boom boom devil fruit, to be exact.
You're just going to tell us your devil fruit?
Yeah, why not? I'm pretty sure his is some magnet related, being the fact that he touched my sword.
Hmm.
It's pretty odd that he just went for my sword.
How did you know Julie was a devil fruit user?
The odd one out. Usually the odd ones out are the devil fruit users. Unless they're really embracing it and just like show.
Hmm.
Don't care.
Yeah.
People know that they're a devil fruit user.
Okay. We're gonna go and talk about our strategy. I hope you have a good day, man. See you around, Florence. It was nice catching up. Oh, and thanks for all the info. I guess some things never change, huh? And remember, you and Sho should stay away from my crew. For your own sake.
They wander off in this direction.
Okay,
Their side of the tournament.
He was never really that strong in training, but now he has a devil fruit, so he might actually be someone we gotta watch out for if we encounter him.
Especially if he blows stuff up.
Yeah.
But yes, the mayor is like in your conversation still.
How are you
like,
everywhere?
Yes. he blows himself up. I've seen him do it. He blew up a couple of bandits outside of town and he killed all 20 of them. One go. It's amazing.
One go. Okay.
I try and pickpocket the mayor.
I wouldn't.
There's no law right now, right?
There's probably law for him.
There are laws.
He's,
there are laws.
He's probably
while
the exception.
While you're in Wrecker's Reef,
Alright.
Hmm. Okay. Who would be a good counter if we end up fighting Dante?
He explodes, right?
Yeah.
Hendrix. He has the metal resistance.
Yeah, Hendrix might actually be a good counter for him. I can...
And technically, I wouldn't be a bad thing either, but we'll see.
You still don't have the metal resistance.
Yeah.
You're still going to have to deal with the flaws. So, like, the attacks that are within 5 feet of you, and they're using a metal object, it draws to you.
I could deal with the explosion.
Like, if they shoot a bullet in your direction, and it's for someone else, and you're within 5 feet of that bullet, it's going to go towards you instead of them.
Okay.
I don't have any resistance to the explosion, but I could deal with the explosions from a distance. But I think Hendrix would be a better counter.
Well, Girl Bear can always rage, too.
Hmm. That's true, yeah. But I think Hendrix would be our best bet for Dante. And then we'll...
Asher whispers in your ear. Should we be talking this in public?
No, we shouldn't.
Hmm. Yeah. We should probably go to a bar or something, right?
Let's go to the back to the Bandit Tavern.
The Bandit Tavern?
Yeah.
Hmm.
The mayor's like, that's the worst place to tell secrets.
Yeah. I kind of agree with the mayor.
Can we get this guy away from us, too? Because I don't trust the mayor, either.
I'm literally waiting for you to sign up. So, I'll leave as soon as you guys sign up.
Oh, let's sign up. Okay.
Fuck.
I gave you...
Just put your 7 members in your benefactor.
Okay.
You said was a Pierre. I haven't met this Pierre yet, have I?
Right there.
He's the one that's passed out over my shoulder.
Well, they have to be conscious.
He's conscious, right, Pierre?
Can I roll?
Pierre, wake up, smack.
Can I roll performance?
Yeah, do a performance.
Yeah, go ahead. You got a minus one. Oh. Oh, it's like a... Oh, this person right here is going to be your benefactor?
No.
Yeah, the one that's groaning.
Oh, he points at you, Kreese.
No. Let me introduce you to Pierre. I just put my arm around D Lightning. This is Pierre.
I'm Pierre.
Don't worry.
Oh, he's conscious. Okay. What? If he's the benefactor, he'll be the one talking for your group. That's fair.
Are you good with that, D Lightning?
I'm good with whatever you need, Dan, because you're my friend.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, he will stay with me and the other benefactors here in town, and if you guys fail to do your task, obviously he'll have to pay the reward, or the bounty.
Mm, yeah.
And if you guys cheat in any way, he will be the one paying with his life.
Do you think we can dress Pierre up in D-Lightning's clothes?
Yeah, I think so.
Pierre's too short.
Mm. We'll put some spacers in his shoes or something, don't worry about it. I do actually have the disguise in my head.
They do also have to willingly choose to be the benefactor, so...
Hmm.
If this is your benefactor, then we will take him. What is your name again? Pierre? Okay. Signing you up, Pierre, as the benefactor for... the 7 deadly sins?
The
squirrel being the sin?
Yeah, we're also pirates.
Okay, yes, that's a good information. Keynote, pirates. And then, your 7 members?
Me, Creef, Zoros, August, Grillbear.
5.
Hendrix, Creef, who do you think should be the 7th?
We could always bring the kid. He needs to be trained.
He could... Yeah,
Julia or the kid?
He could be dead.
Oh, so well. you're going to leave the squirrel here. Got it.
Well, he can't fight. He
whispers in your ear before getting off and going over to D Lightning. Don't worry, I'll tell him what to say.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. Julie, do you think you should go with us or the kid?
Pierre, like, drunkenly tries to get up. What is going on? D Lightning knocks him back out. Nothing, Lightning.
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing.
Maybe we should bring the kid with us?
Kid or Julia?
Sure, he needs experience.
Julia has more power, we'll go with that, but the kid needs training, so it's kind of up to you guys.
They're not that different in power, actually.
Meanwhile, while you guys are doing this...
Yeah, the kid, I guess.
Fuck! Fuck, come back to the Stone Ages. Fuck. Hey, what's up, guys? What's going on?
Hey,
it's me and my band.
We're joining a tournament.
I know.
You know?
Yeah. That's what we're here for, right?
Oh, yeah, good point. Yeah. Yeah, so, kid.
Yeah.
You down to hunt some dinosaurs?
He grabs the kid and he's like, this kid is ready for anything. He's going to be the greatest rock star you've ever seen. You should have seen him on the drums.
Really?
And the kid's like, literally his picture that you see is, he's literally doing that. He's like, it's my first time playing the drums. I don't know what happened.
Good for you, man.
Maybe you're the natural.
Yeah. I feel like one day you'll become a great pirate. You'll probably surpass us all one day. Who knows?
I can see it now. E.T., the Pirate King.
Yeah, maybe. Who knows?
Oh, wait. Kid Pirate. Kid Pirate. Kid the Pirate.
Yeah.
And Hendrick's like, yeah, it's a name in progress, man. That's being a rock star right there. Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and the other two were good.
Really killed it, man.
Did you guys know that August like covers his mouth?
August can
August can dance.
Oh, yeah. I've been meaning to talk to you, August. Last week, when me and Kreeth were bickering, you said if we were in a fight, you'd put your money on Kreeth. But I won that fight, so you owe me, like, some money or something, man.
I was just trying to get you guys to fight. You guys have actually not given me any money, and I don't really care about money, so...
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. You ready to cook a dinosaur, though? But a dinosaur tastes good.
And then the mayor comes back with your task?
Hey,
mayor. Okay, here's your task.
Hey, mayor, one question. Is dinosaur good? What's it taste like? Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Nice.
Oh, sorry, lady. It is very delicious. And we have the Hammond Grill next to this tavern, and it we'll say is to die for.
Can I talk
to a chicken, does it?
Can I talk to Julie real quick?
What do you want, Dan?
Look, if we fail or die or whatever, just kill the mayor.
You didn't expect me to go on this pointless quest to kill dinosaurs, did you?
No. We're taking the kid. If we die...
God, he's gonna die.
Hopefully not. If we die or fail, kill the mayor and take the rest of the crew out of here.
I'm not a murderer, so...
Okay.
Then get everyone out of here.
Just kill the mayor.
Restrain the mayor and get everyone out of here.
Asher's a squirrel, but I guess that would give him the upper hand if he changed back.
Yeah.
Or he could use that crazy nut power he has.
You're in charge of fine soldiers. Well, we're gone.
Alright, here are your three tasks. Are you ready, guys?
Yeah, we were born ready, right, guys?
Task number one.
I was born hairy.
Task number one. Steal a T-Rex egg.
Okay, sounds easy enough. We fought a Kraken, so...
Task number two. Task number two. Kill 10 velociraptors.
How big are they? Like chickens? They're just big chickens, right?
Task number three. Kill any of the other competitors.
What? Everyone's list.
Any of the other teams.
The whole team or just one person?
The whole team.
Find a one man team.
And then the bonus task that everyone has, kill the alpha dinosaur on Doe Island.
If we do that, do we have to do the other tasks?
That's the big reward. You get rewarded for each task you complete.
Okay.
And each task you don't complete when you come back, D-Lightning will have to pay.
Okay, well...
Like, he would have to pay the reward that you would get if you don't complete the task.
Ah, well, we have money. So it's not that big of a deal. I thought they were going to kill him or something.
Yeah, if you cheat.
How would we cheat?
I don't know. You could steal other people's tasks. I don't know. There's a lot of ways you could cheat.
Mm.
You leave the island. That's cheating.
Yeah, I guess, yeah. Okay,
you leave any of the islands while you're in the tournament. That's cheating.
Which one should we go with first? Take the dinosaur egg or fight the velociraptor?
Honestly, you don't want to sound like we could split up for.
What? We don't want to what?
Oh, you did say that everyone got the kill competitors. Nope, only three people got. Only three teams got that one.
That's surprising.
That's not the worst. There was one that you have to kill a whole herd of dinosaurs.
Okay.
You have to kill a whole herd.
Well, hopefully,
yeah, but, you know.
Hopefully we don't find Sho then. I have a feeling he probably has that same task. I don't know why. It just seems like our luck.
You guys know that Sho is on Bray Island.
That's where we're heading, right?
That's where you're at now.
Okay.
So he's not in this village. He's on this island. And you do know he was recently here with the mayor telling you that killed those six pirates easily.
Okay, Zoros, in your opinion, should we go after the egg or fight the velociraptors?
The egg, the...
Yes?
As far as information I can give you, the Doe Island is barbaric with humans and has the most dinosaurs. May Island has dinosaur fanatics. Be careful with them.
So we can go to any of the three islands?
Yes. You can traverse any of the three islands as you please.
Well, we
you will not have my support off of Ray Island. My guards will and soldiers will help you on Ray Island.
Can we kill them on Ray Island?
Who?
The other competitor.
You can kill the other competitors on any island.
Nice. Well, then we should take care of that first.
Yeah. Okay.
Many contestants like to go after the weaker teams for that one.
Okay. Well, we have Grill Bear's vote. What do you think, Zoros? We'll put it up to a vote of what we should do first.
T-Rexes usually live on Doe and May Islands, so for that one, you would have to travel for those islands. But there are velociraptors in all the islands. That isn't much help as I'm going to give you. And that's only because I like you, Dan.
That's creepy.
Thank you, Mayor, I guess.
Zoros. Let's get rid of team.
Zoros, what do you think?
Let's get rid of one of the weaker teams.
Okay, there's two.
Get that one out. Get out of the way.
Two for that. What do you think, Chris?
Well, I already killed a guy for a couple of these gold chains, so yeah, that doesn't sound any.
Let's kill his team.
Okay, August.
His team is in the tavern. If you want to kill his team.
Show's team?
Yeah,
the dinosaur king. The dinosaur king. Last year's winner.
Okay.
Well, do you want to fuck them up?
What do you think, August?
Speaking of which, Kreeth, nice velociraptor outfit, man.
He's wearing gold. He's not wearing...
No. Didn't you take his clothes?
Oh, yeah, you did.
Oh, yeah, I took all his clothes.
He was wearing a raptor cloak, which gives you benefits.
Actually, yeah, I'll put that on.
So you have advantage on dexterity saving throws.
He also got his pants. Does that do anything?
No, they're just normal pants. Okay. And they don't fit Kreeth.
Yeah, they probably fit Grill Bear.
Grill Bear can wear his pants.
Can I give him the Grill Bear? Because I'm pretty sure he's still naked, isn't he?
No, he has overalls.
Yeah, he has overalls. So I'll now he has pants on and overalls.
that's a look.
So good.
Yeah.
Can I tie the pants around my neck? Like
The pants are T-Rex strength.
Nice.
So anytime you're fighting any dinosaurs, you have advantage.
Ah, sweet. So you can fight dinosaurs. Nice.
Dinosaur King pants, and then Velociraptor robe is clothes you got.
Okay. It
just gives you an advantage on dexterity saving throws.
August, what do you think?
It does move your movement speed up to 10.
Oh, nice.
Oh, okay. So how would I add this? How do I edit it?
So that would be just add a cloak, then you would modify it from there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Or you could just remember what it does and add that later, probably.
Yeah.
The mayor's like, and I will stay with your non-competitors and mingle with them.
Okay, D-Lightning.
Especially that one with the glasses. I'm intrigued about her.
She's poisonous.
Don't try it, man.
Oh, don't worry. I don't swing that way, but I do like a woman with confidence.
She's poisonous.
August, what do you think? What's your vote?
God damn it. All right, well, killing the competitors would be easy if we got easy competitors. The dinosaur egg, we have to travel for another island, and the raptors are everywhere. So, obviously, the raptors is the easiest bet.
Yeah, maybe.
Wait, hey, actually, how easy is it to kill a raptor? Oh, well, it says you gotta kill 10 of them. And they usually hunt in packs of 20 to 30, so...
Yeah, but they're not that big.
Meat bomb.
It's the... They're in a pack is a problem.
Yeah, they're only like 2 or 3 feet, though. It'd be like fighting a bunch of angry ducks.
The dinosaurs on this island are grotesquely bigger than what they should be.
Did you fuck with them? Did you mutate them or something?
No, maybe the people did before, but that's why we're trying to get rid of them. They're too big. Your territories are too big.
Okay, so your vote is to maybe kill the people or the raptors first. Okay, what about you, Hendrix? What's your vote?
I go for rocking the heads off of those raptors.
Okay, so
If we have to kill some other competitors, I like that too. But that T-Rex egg, that sounds like it's gonna be the hardest one.
So no concrete answer, I guess.
We should keep it, because he never said we have to kill it, and then we can...
Yeah, do we get to keep the egg, or do we have to give it to you?
Oh, you just have to bring the egg to me. I don't care what you do with it afterwards. Eat it, keep it, whatever. As long as you take that egg off this island.
Listen, guys, we could have a T-Rex as a pet.
Yeah,
It will literally the egg will literally take up both your hands, and you won't be able to fight if you hold the egg.
Okay. What about you, kid?
The raptors, I guess? Well, the competitors sounds like an easy option if it... I don't know.
Okay, so what I'm getting is we should probably kill the competitors first and then go after the raptors and then the T-Rex.
Well, if there's competitors... Hang on. Hendrix has an idea. And yes, I talked in third person. Get over it.
Okay, Hendrix.
What if raptors and the competitors are fighting each other? We take them both out.
That's very... scummy, Hendrix.
Yeah, but it's not. Yeah.
It didn't say we couldn't do it.
Yeah, but could we live with ourselves?
We could.
We're pirates. Okay. I mean,
like, what is your...
Yeah.
What is your dilemma?
Okay, fine. Raptors first, then. We could just go kill those guys in the bar, but I guess raptors first, then.
You would have to kill them in the bar, and who's to say that others won't join their side?
Fair point. Raptors first, then.
But they only have 6 members in there.
Where can we find the raptors on this island, old man?
Who wants to come to the bar with me and take...
Well, recently...
No splitting up.
One of our villages to the north was ambushed by a pack of raptors. And they were led by some human.
Hmm. What did this human look like?
He's claiming himself to be the Raptor King. Probably from Doe Island, honestly. He's been leading a resistance against us ever since.
You want to go kick the shit out of the Raptor King, guys? I guess let's go do that. Do we get bonus if we take out the Raptor King?
No, it was not part of one of your tasks. Although, one of the teams that came here, that was one of their tasks.
Well, let's see in case we can find them, whoever's task it is, and kill them while we kill the Raptor.
If we take another team's task, do they get punished for not completing it?
Yes, as much as you would.
Hmm. Well, we gotta fight the Raptors anyway. Is the Raptor King a competitor?
He is not a competitor. He is a nuisance in my thorn. I do not give him a bounty because I like to treat everyone here bountyless. Oh, I never told you the great reward for completing all 4 tasks.
Uh-huh.
Pay your bounties. Now, for really? the Marines, they just asked me to collect certain bounties.
What, so you just say we died? Why would we want that?
Do they want evidence then?
Yeah, why would we want that, though?
Well, I mean, it would give our bounties off.
Some people want that.
Yeah, but the whole point of being a pirate is to have a bounty. Otherwise, they'll think we're fucking losers. We'll get made fun of by the other pirates.
There's a secret reward if you complete a secret task, but I'm not allowed to tell you the secret task, so...
Okay.
Intimidation?
Yeah, go ahead.
You want to intimidate him?
You did not intimidate him. He has a +6 to charisma saving throws. Let's see if you intimidate him. You do not.
Just barely.
Listen, big bear. You're not the first big intimidating person that thinks they could talk to me like that. But I'm gonna let it slide. A bunch of soldiers are, like, getting ready to attack at his will. I like you guys.
Grubber, too.
And I hope you guys actually, succeed at killing these filthy dinosaurs.
Mm-hmm. Do you know...
the muck of my island. Islands, now. Because I own all of them now.
So, are we going after the raptors, guys? Is that what we're doing?
And then when you guys come back, because this is every day, mm-hmm. you're allowed to come back, even though you haven't completed your task. It's a 3-day thing,
mm-hmm.
right?
Okay.
You're allowed to come back, recuperate, heal up, whatever.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sounds good.
Any musical contestants will have to perform that night. And Hendrix is like, oh, shit.
What did you do, Hendrix?
Well, we're in that, so...
Well, just drop out of it.
We definitely have to make it back by night. No, drop out of my dream!
Your dream is to play at a dinosaur island?
You don't understand the reward of this contest.
What's the reward?
We'll be worldwide. Signed.
Okay.
And we'll get paid heftily. Like, who's talking million berries?
Okay, who's in your band?
August, the kid, and the bear.
You took 2 of our heavy hitters be in your band.
Well, we just have to show up tonight for the first round. That's it.
Okay, fine. Okay, let's go to the Raptors.
That's in 5 hours. You can do that in 5 hours?
Maybe we should split up the bear stay here.
Nope.
And try to kill the bar dudes.
No, we're not splitting up. That's how we end up dying.
Why don't we just try and kill the bar guys before we leave? Kill that team, and then we go hunt raptors after their competition.
Okay. What if we...
Because then we're still in town.
Creep, why don't you lure them out into the open, that way the other bar people don't come and help them.
Speaking of which,
you said they wanted you to join their crew, right? So just
a bunch of the bar attendees come out, at least 13 of them. Mm. Where's the new dinosaur king? And they all look at Kreese.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, are you guys competitors?
Oh shit. I didn't realize there was a new Dinosaur King. Yeah, all the competitors are kind of after you now.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
Creep. Hey, are you guys competitors, by the way?
They all raise their hands.
Oh, nice. Nice. How many are there?
One team.
Yeah, are you all one team?
Yeah, our team, we had to, we don't have a full team of seven, so we had to back out. You killed our leader. But that's fine. He was an asshole.
Are you still active competitor?
He always made us go to... No, we had to back out. We don't have a full team.
Do you know where some competitors may be that we can fight?
There's a couple in here, but it's mixed parties.
Cool. Can you convince them to come out here?
Most teams send out their strongest members to go kill the dinosaurs, and then the rest of them chill here.
Hmm.
Except for those Marines. They all went out full first.
Okay, can you go and tell them the new Dinosaur King is out here and have them come out here, and then we can jump them?
Dan, are you using me as bait?
Possibly.
I don't mean to intrude, but I'm still here, obviously. You want to kill members outside of the tavern?
Yeah, we don't want people to come and gang up on us.
So you want to break my law?
Yeah,
you said we're killing them.
Yeah, you said
we kill them.
Yeah, you are free to kill outside of my village.
Fine.
Or in that bar, they don't care about murder in that bar.
But not in the middle of the street.
He actually keeps tracks.
Fuck it.
Well, yeah, I gotta keep some civility. You animals.
What if we put a bag over it?
Here, Creep. Alchemist.
His name is Creep, the one that's wearing the Dinosaur King's robe.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Okay, so. Yes, there's a big target on your head now. I didn't realize that you killed him recently.
Okay, Creep, you still have that alchemist fire I have? Shoot an arrow at that bar.
Okay.
Let's just set it on fire.
Whoa. Arsony is still against the law.
Oh my god! Fine, let's go into the bar then. Fucking making our life harder, goddamn.
So, are we just killing everyone in the bar? You guys want to go in the bar?
Yeah.
Well, we can't come out here because there's fire.
The mayor tells the soldiers to wait out, and he's like, hang on, I want to see this plays out. This is going to be funny. Watch.
Oh, goddammit.
You guys go inside the tavern. Yeah, go ahead and kill them all.
We're not going to kill them all. We're just going to kill the competitors.
Hey, you need to kill a full team.
Hey,
kill a full team.
Is anybody a competitor
in here? They all raise their hand.
We have 1,000,000 berries
So there's only seven people in this bar?
No, there's not a full team in this bar, is what the mayor keeps trying to tell you.
Yeah, so you're kind of dense.
There's no point.
You can. He literally goes, you can kill them all. But you wouldn't complete that task, would you now?
Okay.
We can't kill them now, kill the rest later?
So we can't
go all at once?
So we can't go after...
How are you going to know which people are part of a team?
So we can't go after the raptors until 5 hours from now, and we can't kill the people in the bar.
Wait, you can go after the raptors right now. You just have to be back here in 5 hours.
Oh, then fuck it. Let's go after the raptors.
That's your captain? The mayor goes, that's your captain? You really let him lead you?
He's kind of an idiot.
Julia's like, don't remind me.
Oh, shit.
All right, good luck, guys. If any of you die, we will pay a life insurance fee, but...
To who? Who gets the life insurance?
Well, the captain or the benefactor.
Oh, okay.
So that would be you, Pierre. You get the reward if one of them dies. Yeah.
Thank God.
Okay.
Thank God.
We're so
screwed. Pierre's ears perk up. My name? Dan knocks him out again. Lightning.
he's
my buddy. He gets drunk all the time. That's why we call him D-Lightning. Drunk Lightning.
Okay. So which direction is the raptors again? Just forward?
Well, there was a town ransacked north from here.
Mm-hmm.
Of raptors, and there are raptor packs all throughout the three islands.
Okay.
Meat bomb.
The one we know of for sure is that north island to the north. They killed all my men and all the people in the village.
I guess you guys want to go there?
I have told every competitor about this, by the way. Just letting you know.
So there might be other competitors there then?
Most definitely.
Well, we could take two birds with a stone if we're lucky. Do you guys want to do that, or do you want to look for...
Like I said, only three teams out of the 10 have actually ventured out of this town with a full team, including yours. Well, I guess four now, if you guys all leave in a full team.
Yeah.
So there are still technically a full team outside. It's just, it's the Marines and a couple others. The but there's three full teams.
Well, and technically, the Marine full team that's out there doesn't have one of their members.
Okay, well, where a full team might be is...
I have no idea. We don't keep track of that. Actually, we do.
But benefactor is?
That would be cheating. The benefactor? Yes, he's in my palace right now.
Okay.
Is he the red guy?
What?
The rock guy?
The rock guy was here, killed a bunch of bandits, told his team that he's going to go off on the task on his own. And then his team left. His team actually just left.
I see. Okay, let's, you guys want to go after the Raptor King guy or whatever? There might be other competitors there.
The likes of him, I like him. He sounds like a fun guy.
Yeah, sure, let's go.
Okay, let's go that way, I guess.
That's... If you kill the Raptor King, make sure you bring back his, body. The whole body. And everything he owns.
Okay, but that's not one of our tasks.
I know it's not, but I will reward you for bringing that back.
Okay. I guess we head that way then. That's where we're all going. That's what we decided.
I also told this to the other competitors.
Just now?
I have told every competitor about this.
Yeah, so we might find a full team of competitors that we can take out. I don't really want to kill a bunch of people, but fuck it, I guess. Don't have much of a choice. Probably.
Alright, so you guys head north?
Yeah, they're probably also scumbags anyways, considering they're...
It's about an hour's walk.
Okay. Does Kree sober up then?
Yeah, I'll be sober by that point.
Okay.
So you guys, he's only drunk for an hour, so...
Okay. Yeah, that's where we go.
So you guys traverse, and I'm gonna roll a d20 to see what you encounter on your way there.
You know, it's pretty crazy. This is like the second forest island we've been on. So this one's more like a jungle.
Yes, it's... Pretty crazy. There's a desert in May Island, big vast desert.
Well, that sucks.
And then it goes back into tropical areas.
That wouldn't be great for me or Zoros then.
All right, I have you on the new map, and you guys rolled a 2, so that's what you're fighting.
A 2? What's a 2?
Oh, I rolled what you guys were gonna encounter on the way there.
Oh, okay. The map hasn't changed though.
Yeah, I know. I'm moving you guys right now.
Oh, okay.
So. How do you guys want to be ordered?
I'm behind Grill Bear.
Ordered. Let's see. Guy. Yeah, probably me, Grill Bear, and Hendrix, and August would be further up since we're more durable. And then Zoros and Kreeth, and then the kid.
I'll just let you guys do it then.
Zoros is really strong. Wait, how durable are you, Zoros?
Are
you
guys on the map? Let's see. 16 strength, 13 AC.
You have 21 strength because of your belt.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead and reorder your guys is however you want.
Oh, okay. There we are. I would say Grill Bear would be in front of the kid, and then August would be in front of Kreeth, and that would probably be pretty good. Like, the kid would be in the back. We can't
move. Wait, are we heading south or north?
North is where we were supposed to go.
Yeah, you're going north.
So why is Grill Bear in the back?
Oh, yeah. Okay. And then, Kreeth would probably be... I would move behind Zoros, Kreeth, especially since you're a rogue. Kreeth, you there, bud?
Is that okay?
Oh, I didn't hear you. Your mic must have cut out. There you go. Yeah, that should be good. Yeah, that works. That's our order. So what are we fighting, Austin?
You break up again.
Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah.
We can hear you.
Oh, shit. Hendrix is just singing, rocking to the stone. It just rocking.
Shut up.
Okay.
Who has the highest passive perception?
Let's see. My passive...
Hendrix has a 14. August has...
I have a
11.
14. Mine's 14 as well.
Anybody higher than a 15?
Yeah, 12. No.
So, you guys do not know of this. You are ambushed.
Kreeth, what's your passive? Are you higher than a 15?
No, I'm 11, dude.
Oh, okay. Yeah, my passive perception is 14, yeah. Okay. What attacks us?
You guys are ambushed as this woman with bows and arrows starts shooting at you.
That's great.
Lovely.
She's gonna shoot at Dan.
Okay.
She's got 2 attacks and a plus 7.
Okay.
No, neither one of those hits.
Yeah, a 2 and a 9? Is that what she got?
Oh, she rolled a 6 and a 3 plus 7, so...
Yeah, that's 9.
That's 13.
6 plus 3?
6 plus 7.
Where do you see 7?
He said that she gets a plus 7.
Oh, okay.
Because she ambushed us.
Oh, okay.
She got a bonus, but she still doesn't hit because you have an AC of like 18, don't you?
Yeah, I can also catch missiles technically and reduce it if it did hit. But no, it doesn't hit. My AC is 18. Okay. Are you there, Austin?
Yep, I'm here. Okay, Kreese, you notice there are 3 guys behind you.
Did someone just shoot an arrow at me?
Oh, definitely.
these two are gonna attack Kreese.
Are we able to tell that they're here now?
After their ambush round.
Okay.
And then you guys roll initiative. These two guys are gonna attack Kreese with crossbows. They have a plus 4. Oh, one of them nat 20's Kreese. And the other one misses.
Are they metal? Can't he absorb metal stuff?
Not yet.
Okay.
This is at the point where he's still attracting the metal. So that nat 20 hits Kreese for 2d6 plus 2.
Hmm.
And then this one tries to hit the kid. Does not hit with a plus 4.
Okay.
All right. And then you see...
So we see them now?
Yeah, they're
1, 2, triggering 3, 4, their 5, ambush. 6. Which one of you is missing? Seems like a full team, but you only have 6. Oh.
And these guys are attacking from the hiding. Right. This is more than 7.
Yeah, what the fuck?
This might be multi-teams.
This might not be a team.
Ooh, Groby is the most perceptive.
This might be what?
This might be those raptor, dude.
Oh, yep.
No, you guys are bandits. These are just bandits.
So, you guys are bandits and you're going after pirates? That's a really dumb move on your part.
They're trying to kill contestant members. Okay, so Dan, he has a plus 3 to hit with his daggers. He gets 2 attacks. None of those hit. August, same thing, plus 3. One of them crits on August, and I think the other one hits.
August AC should be 16, right?
It's 15.
Yeah, but it's plus 3.
Oh, okay.
So August gets hit twice, and one of them crits. This is 2d4s plus 2, so he takes 8 damage, and then 16 damage.
You doing okay, man?
If I lied and said yes, would you be more comfortable with fighting these guys instead of just dodging arrows?
How messed up are you?
I just got stabbed twice.
Yeah,
tell me.
Scale of 1 to 10. Well, I was stabbed and I was pretty fine. So,
you're not a very good doctor, are you?
I can't do anything. It's not my round. How am I supposed to fucking do anything, Kreese?
No, but you're asking really dumb questions.
Okay, how many doctors can look at someone and know exactly how hurt they are?
How bad is it? I got stabbed.
The really good ones.
Okay, I can do a fucking medicine check if you want.
That would be on your turn. It would be a bonus action. So I don't know if you want to do that.
Yeah, so there's no way in hell I can tell how hurt he is.
Okay, so this one's attacking August, same thing. Or not August, Zoros.
At least
thing.
I'm not a horrible ass thief. That fails every time.
That's a plus 3. Neither one of those hit you, Zoros.
What is it?
13. 13
14,
AC.
14. You have 13 AC?
Yep.
They both
why
hit.
Do you have? Why do you have no armor?
I thought you had a shield. Are you not? Is your shield not equipped?
I think he's actually dual wielding the
trident. Hold on. Since I have a lantern's trident, I can wield the greatsword one-handed, so therefore, theoretically,
I think that only works in the water, though.
It doesn't say.
No. If he's using that feat I made, it just is a thing in general.
Oh, it says your ability score was already increased, so that doesn't matter whether or not you're in water.
Yeah. You could dual wield,
yeah. It says right here, you are stronger underwater. All stats increased by 1.
Yeah, that's just his default thing. He's talking about
Atlantean strength.
Yeah.
8.
Plus 1. Two-handed. You can two-hand weapons in one hand. Okay. Yeah. Go ahead and equip your shield if you have it.
Yeah, he's talking
that
about...
That matter.
Yeah, he's talking about his feet.
Yeah, you have a shield. Go ahead and equip that. Make sure that's equipped.
Yeah, you can wield two-handed weapons in one hand. So, yeah.
Yep.
So, yeah, you could use your
shield.
What's your AC now?
15.
Okay, so... Good.
Good. So, neither one of those hit. All right, Kreef, you're the last person.
Come on, Kreef.
Both those hit.
Both those hit.
Damn it.
13 and an 18.
So, yeah. This is the... It's 2d4 plus 2, and then just do that twice. So 7 damage, 14 damage you took.
That's not That's pretty bad for Kreeth. I don't think Kreeth has a ton of health.
All right. 30, but that hurt.
Yeah. Oh,
roll initiative.
Okay. Just a d20?
It's in your initiative bar. Make sure you click on your token before you roll initiative.
Oh, then I've probably been rolling initiative wrong.
No, you guys all got in there. I got her in twice. All right. She has a plus 2.
Bear got a nat 20 on his initiative.
Yeah, I got 11.
There's another way to nat 20. Grover, you get 2 actions because you rolled a nat 20. And I'm a kind DM like that.
Who's missing in the initiative?
Why is Pierre here?
Is Pierre here?
No, he was in the turn initiative.
Oh.
7.
That's weird.
Kreeth got a 10. You got 11. Mm-hmm. You're on here twice. All right, we're all on there.
Who got a 0?
That's the archer that shot at you.
Okay.
She is going 14. The roguelike bandits, the ones that shooting crossbows, they are going at 16. And the ones that stabbed you guys on the right, they are going at 7.
Okay. What about August and Hendrix and the kid?
Oh, I gotta roll them right now.
Well, a good thing Grill Bear goes before all of them. That's good. Do you have 2 attacks, by the way, Brenna? Or do you only have 1 attack?
Yes, I have a friend attack.
Okay, so Grill Bear, you are going first because you rolled a nat 20.
Oh, Hendrix got pretty good, too.
Oh, yeah.
Where's the kid, though?
He got a 16.
I got him. He's 16.
Okay.
Oh, there he is, yeah.
First things first.
His thing was really small. I didn't.
You get 2 actions. Remember that. Rage is bonus action.
And,
So you're raging?
Then I'm gonna go ahead and move myself to here, in front of the kid, and block some arrows.
And you're gonna kill that
then
guy?
Then can I attempt to throw an axe? What would I roll for that?
And that's a normal attack roll. That will take 1 of your actions.
I hope I forgot to add my axes back.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead and add them.
How do I add them?
Go to inventory and click on the box.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then you just go to add item. You type in hand axe. You had 2 hand axes.
And then it's just... Okay, there we go. And which one do I roll for the throw? Just the attack?
Yeah, you just click on the hand axe. I'll do 1 of them for you. Unless you don't want me to. 18 hits.
Nice.
Awesome. And I'm gonna do another one.
You're gonna throw all both right, hand axes?
This would be both your actions.
Damn, which ones are you hitting? The 2 in front of you?
they both hit.
Yeah,
if you're just going
right
for this guy.
Yeah,
alright, give me damage. Give me damage.
Okay.
Wait, you're hitting the guy in front of you 2 times?
4, and then you get to add... This is a strength weapon, so you get to add your rage modifier to that.
My rage modifier?
Yes, okay. You have advantage on strength saving throws, plus 2 to melee damage with strength weapons. So you get to add plus 2 to that damage.
Okay.
So you did a total of...
11?
18 damage.
Oh.
7 plus 6, that's not 18.
I think that's 13.
It's 15. Oh, yeah, it is 13. No, it's not. Is it? Yeah.
It says 13. 4 and 5 on the screen.
Yeah, but he gets a plus 2.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, to both. Okay. That's why. Never mind.
You did 13 damage to this guy as he has 2 hand axes in his chest. Ah! Ah! Barbaric asshole.
That's what you get for sneaking up on somebody.
That's your turn, Groby. Hendrix is gonna go. Hendrix is gonna do what he does best.
Yeah, Hendrix.
Bonus action. He's gonna two weapon fighting his drill fist.
Nice. I think he failed the second one though, didn't he?
He did miss that second one. But the first one's a crit, and he's hitting the one that is on Kreeth.
Nice.
So he does 14 damage.
Hell yeah.
And this sends him back 5 feet as he's getting hit with this drill.
Nice.
Kid's turn. All right. I guess I attack somebody. Who do I attack? Who do I attack, guys?
Get the one off either Kreeth or August, since they're kind of injured.
He goes down right here and attacks this one. All right. Here I go.
Does he...
Oh, my father.
Nice.
All the people that doubted me at that mining village.
Hell yeah!
Well, he misses the second one, but the first one does 8 damage.
Yeah, but it's still good for him.
Alright, it's their turn.
Okay.
This one is going to whip out his 2 daggers. And, Groby, give me a perception check. Groby, perception check?
Yeah, I'm just getting to it, my bad.
Otherwise, he's just gonna stab you and you're gonna feel it.
Don't wipe your butt now.
Is that an action or skill?
Don't wipe your butt.
his skills, perception.
Okay.
Dang.
This guy has a plus 4. I don't think either one of those hit. You notice that these guys have poison tip daggers, Groby. Don't get hit with those.
Nice.
These guys.
Can I say that I have poison tip daggers? They have poison tip daggers?
Yeah, you can announce that. You perceived it.
Their max got poison, bros. Watch out.
These guys have poison tip daggers that will poison you.
You might want to back up, kid.
Oh, it's just an extra
way to get damage. The kid hears this and he's like, poison tip daggers, as this guy next to him goes to stab him twice.
Hmm. Wow.
They both hit.
Yeah. So the kid's unconscious?
It's not that poison. So poison in D&D is a side effect. Go ahead and look it up if you really want to know.
How much damage did it do the kid?
It's going to do 2d4 damage. And if he fails a constitution saving throw, so it did 7 damage twice. So 14 damage. Ooh, he is unconscious.
Yeah, he's probably knocked out. Ah, shit. No shame, kid. No shame.
And
he did well.
And he is also poisoned.
Yeah, well, I can probably take care of that when we get to that.
Poison creature has disadvantage on attack rolls and ability checks.
Oh.
He's supposed to drum for us later. Screw you guys.
Well, that doesn't really seem to do much now that he's unconscious, though.
This guy goes straight for Kreeth.
Come on, Kreeth.
Well, one misses on the good note. The second note, he crits you.
How do you figure out how far away someone is again from you?
There's a little ruler. Oh, this is not supposed to be 10 feet. Let me switch that.
Nope.
There should be 5 feet settings. These guys should be 5 feet apart from you guys.
How close is Kreeth to me? Okay, never mind. I can't do shit then.
So Kreeth,
you're on your own in that case.
2d4 plus 2 damage, and then you gotta roll con saving throw to be poisoned. Hey, 5 damage ain't too bad.
Mm.
And it wouldn't be bad if I wouldn't have already been hit like 3 or 4 times.
Yeah.
And then roll me a constitution saving throw to determine whether or not you're poisoned.
You can disengage though when it's your turn.
The DC is high. You're not poisoned. You're not poisoned.
I would use your mobility feat to disengage when it's your turn.
He can bonus action disengage.
Yeah,
he's a rogue. But it is this one's turn up here. One up here.
Mm-hmm.
And he has a poison-tipped crossbow. And he's going to shoot at Dan.
Okay.
He gets a plus 4, and he crits Dan.
What is it? A 20?
Jeez, I'll crit tonight.
Okay, let's see. What's the cap? What's the...
You can deflect missiles with the key point.
Yeah, I'm trying to find where that at. I'll deflect
your
missiles.
Features and traits.
Okay, you can use your reaction to deflect or catch the missile when you are hit by a ranged weapon attack. When you do so, the damage you take from that attack is reduced by 1d10 plus 9. If you reduce damage to 0, you have a free hand. You can spend 1 key point to make a ranged attack as a monk weapon with a range of 20 to 60 feet.
Yeah, okay. So you can send this anywhere you want, if you want.
So 1d10 plus 9. Okay.
That's if you want to take the bullet or take the arrow, which you do not.
Okay. So I can deflect it?
Yeah, you can deflect it to someone else. I think that's a key point.
It doesn't. Can I catch it then?
Deflect missile. Catch missile, blah blah blah. Reduce the damage to 0 if you have a free hand, which you do. Spend 1 key point to make a range attack as a monk weapon with range of 20. So you basically send the missile somewhere else.
Yeah.
With a key point.
If I reduce it to 0, I can do what I want with it.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm going to roll its damage. It's 2d6 plus 2.
Fucking, really? 1? Okay, so it did 9. So I reduced it by 9. How much damage did it do? No, I reduced it by 10.
So you reduce it to 0. You can send it.
Okay.
Well, actually, it's doubled because of crit. So, 12. So you can't send it at someone else, but you take 3 damage.
I take 2 damage.
2, yeah.
Yeah, okay. I guess I'll do that. So I, like, barely catch it as it hits my skin.
You do have to make a constitution saving throw, though.
Okay. Do I get advantage since it didn't fully pierce me?
No, it just has to break skin.
Okay. Just a con save?
Yep, con save of 12. You're poisoned.
Mm, that's great.
You have disadvantage on attacking rolls and an ability check.
Well, when it's my turn, I can cure the poison with my fucking walk it off shit, yes. But I gotta wait.
Then do that. Fuck. Disadvantage, attack rolls, and ability checks.
I just snap
and
there.
That walk it off, I feel like the walk it off is a bonus action, right?
Some stuff is bonus actions. I think I can heal others as a free action, but I think everything else is a bonus action.
All right. Kreath, it is your turn.
I'll read through it. Well, it's Kreath's turn. Administer medicine. You can administer free action. Select missile. Where the fuck is that? Unarmored strike. Position healing? No. Where the fuck is walk it off at? Oh, here it is. What are you doing, Kreath?
I go help Rail Bear out. Since he's almost killed this guy real quick.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it would be a bonus. Walk it off as a bonus action. You got the one.
So you choose to help Grover over the kid. I like it.
Yeah, you did.
This guy's almost dead.
The kid is down. The kid is down.
You could have grabbed the kid and disengaged and then snuck attack them and got, like, double damage on one.
I'm busy.
You're busy.
All right, so go ahead and roll the damage. I will give you the sneak attack.
Hey, Austin, what is my token in the turn order?
7.
I'm not seeing the list, though.
You're not seeing the turn order?
Well, he sees the turn order, but his icon's not on there.
Yeah, under the bandit, there should be a 7.
Okay. What are you doing, Kreath?
I'm attacking the bandit that Grillbear attacked, so hopefully it's dead, so we have one less guy to deal with.
Yeah. Sneak attacking does give you, like, double damage, though.
So, Kreath, you kill him. How do you kill him?
Slice his throat.
Okay, you slit his throat. He is dead. Just to let you know, Grillbear did 13 damage to him, so that gives you a...
And how much did Kreath do?
I did 17.
So that gives you somewhat of a range of how much health these guys have.
They have at max 30.
They have more than 13.
They have at max 30, but could have less than that.
Is that your turn, Kreath? Because that was your attack and bonus action. All right, the chick blows a whistle and then shoots an arrow at Dan.
Everybody's shooting an arrow at me.
This is plus 7.
Uh-huh.
I think she only hits you with 1.
Yeah, I could... try to block it again, I guess.
Yeah.
How much damage does it do?
Go ahead and roll your die. I'll roll the damage if you're allowing it to hit. It is 2d6 plus 4.
Oh, sweet. I got 19.
She only did 6 damage, so you can redirect that arrow any way you want.
Okay, so I got a
key point.
Yep, so I will throw it at the guy behind me.
So this guy.
Uh-huh.
So you want him to take that full damage? It's a range attack that you make.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it counts as a monk weapon when I catch it.
Do you want to just roll the damage die?
If you reduce
that,
Yeah.
Go ahead as if, like, you were rolling as her. So roll 2d6s plus 4.
Okay.
And that's how much damage you'll do.
2d6s plus 4?
Yeah. It says roll an attack, a ranged attack. So, like, there's a chance you can miss.
Yeah.
So go ahead and roll a d20 and then plus your dex modifier.
Okay. Well, that would be the damage plus 4, so that'd be 4, 5, 6, 7 damage if it hits, I guess. And then,
yeah. And then go ahead and roll a d20 plus your dex modifier.
Okay, so d20 plus 3.
Plus 3.
15, 16, 17, 18.
That definitely hits, so you do 7 damage to this guy.
Yeah, I like to imagine I grab it and then just casually throw it behind me at the guy.
So you're just like, whoosh.
Yeah.
I haven't took my eyes off you, little lady. Yeah. Shooting arrows at me.
How's it going?
Dan, it is your
turn. That guy poisoned, by the way? Does he have to make a con save?
No, she doesn't use poison arrows.
Okay. It's my turn. Sweet. First off, I will go and attack this one by the kid. I will do unarmed strike.
Did you do walk it off?
That's a bonus action. I can do that. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I'll
but
do
that limits how many times you can
attack.
Yeah, just
attack, let me
though.
Yeah, I'll do walk it off.
Remember, you're
yeah, I know.
Spending your key points as a bonus action, yeah.
Yeah, I can only attack twice then, right? Or 3 times. Twice, I think.
So not only do you heal yourself, you cure yourself of poison. Okay. Oh, wait, no, it says heal yourself or attempt to cure yourself.
Yeah, I will.
So you just...
Well, yeah, I'll just heal myself.
Heal yourself of poison.
Yeah, so I'm no longer poisoned. So, yeah,
It does say you can only do this.
Yes.
It doesn't say you can do this to somebody else.
Yeah,
right, yeah.
I have a different thing for
other. Can you punch him?
Yep.
11 damage. Are you doing any of your?
Yeah, I'll do the force damage.
Hang on. Yeah, the force damage.
That was D6. Yeah, that was one D6.
I'm gonna send him back 5.
And I'll use one of my charges. Wow, that's the worst roll I could have got, but whatever.
So you did 12 damage to him.
Yeah.
And you send him back 5 feet.
Mm-hmm.
Which direction do you want to send him back? This way?
Can I send him into the other guy?
Yeah. This one?
Yeah.
So you want to be right here then?
Yeah.
Okay, so you send him back and you do that D6 to the other guy too.
Okay, so just one damage to the other guy? Or do I roll it?
So you did 12 to this guy.
One to the other guy?
You did one to this guy.
Okay. And then I will use my unarmed strike to take out the guy I attacked again.
Can you do that without a bonus action? Oh, no, you got 2 attacks.
Yep.
You're good. You're going to punch him again? That does not hit.
Nope, it doesn't.
All right, that's your turn, right?
Yeah, I don't have another bonus action, so I don't... Yeah, that's my turn. Okay.
Well, Creef, you weren't supposed to go yet, but that's fine. We'll just have you go at 16. August's turn. August sees these two guys, and he's like, all right, let's take these guys out.
Yeah, August. Damn.
Jesus.
Holy fuck, August. No chill.
Someone wants to... Oh, it's murder face them all.
Holy fuck.
So he swings his ivory fang twice at the bottom guy, and he is one-handing that. So he did a total of 13 damage to that guy, and the other one, not 113.
That guy would be super and dead.
The other guy, he does 7 damage to you. And they're both still alive. And I'm pretty sure that's all August can do, because he uses bonus action to two-weapon fighting.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait, no, he has... He has the feat to weapon fighting, doesn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, so he has an extra bonus action. I don't know what he can do with it, though.
Dual wielding expert, blah, blah, blah. Light, you can use it as not light weapon. You don't have to, they don't have to be light weapons. You can stow 2 weapons. It doesn't take an action. If he takes a certain stance. Oh, okay. So he has a +1 bonus to attack rolls, which that was already added in.
Yeah.
Okay, so everything's added in. I was just making sure. Yeah, so nothing changed.
Yeah, he can make stances to do more damage or increase his armor class, but I don't think he'd do
that. All right.
You could take a defensive stance as his bonus action if you wanted, right?
Hey, so?
No, okay, so it's not an action or bonus action. He can do that before attacking.
Oh, okay.
If he chooses defensive action, he raises his AC, he takes the aggressive stance, he gets a +1 to his attacks, which they already added it.
Okay.
Or I would have added it if it mattered, which it didn't, because they both hit.
Yeah. Okay, so it's Zoros' turn?
It is Zoros' turn, and then after these guys go, we'll end the session here.
Okay.
Hey, someone tap the guy in front of me.
And you are one-handing this sword, right? Because you got your shield on now?
You can... Can you attack twice?
So I'm just saying... Yeah. Yeah, he can attack twice, but I'm saying, like, there's the damage difference.
Oh, yeah.
One-handed and two-handed. Because you look, when he does his damage, it'll ask him two-handed or one-handed. Wow. That is a lot of damage. You kill this guy.
Okay. You guys still want to fight us?
You know, you all look delicious. I'm going to eat your flesh and drink your blood.
We have no choice. You wish to participate in this tournament, you are our enemy.
Okay, fine by me. We'll kill you all anyways.
Okay, we end in the session?
Yeah.
Okay. Does the kid get 500, by the way? Are we...
Horror for the night?
What the fuck? My headphones not working?
Did you hear me, Zoros?
No.
Do you have a bonus action?
Holy shit, my headphones must have not been working.
Do you have a bonus action, Zoros? Did nobody hear me?
I don't know.
What's up, Boston?
Oh, okay, you can hear me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Zoros, you have a bonus action.
Yeah.
So, mine's gonna be... And so when Dan gets attacked next time, I'm going to use my...
Interception?
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Okay. So opposed disadvantage?
They have to be within 5 feet, right?
We're probably in that.
That close enough, might as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that...
You guys are all...
That imposes disadvantage?
And it's with melee attacks. It's melee attacks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It imposes disadvantage, right?
It does.
It does.
Nice.
Alright, these two up top attack August, and they get 2 attacks, so here's the top one. The first one hits for 2d4 +2, 7 damage to August.
Hopefully August is doing well. What's August?
I'm getting stabbed more, Dan!
Yeah, I can
just
see that.
Just letting you know, medic, I'm getting stabbed.
I'll get to it when I get to it. We're kind of surrounded right now.
August is at half health. And then the other one attacks August, +2.
Does it hit him?
August, only one of them does.
How close is August to me?
2d4 plus 2.
I can't seem to use the rule.
Oh, hang on. Zoros, did you want me to use that on August?
Yep.
It would take up your reaction, though.
That's fine.
That means you can only do it once.
Yeah, with a turn. It's either Dan or him, and no, Dan can handle himself.
Yeah, I'm also pretty much unhurt.
I will roll another 20 and take the lesser out of that in the 16.
I've only taken 2 damage, so I'm probably okay.
So he doesn't get hit the second time. You saved him taking more damage.
Nice.
All right, and the last one's going to attack Dan.
Okay.
2d4s. Of course, one of them crits.
Hmm.
This is plus 2.
Okay.
So this is 2d4 plus 2.
Yeah, so he misses 1 and hits 1.
He did 10 damage to you. And these are not poison daggers. He does 10 damage to you.
Okay.
Are you okay with that?
Yeah. There's nothing I can do to defend myself. So,
next time, we'll start with Girl B.
Yep.
You have taken down 2 opponents.
I'm still pretty okay, though, compared to
everybody else. Everybody gets 500 for this session.
It says I can administer a med kit as a free action to my allies. Does that have to be on my turn, or can it be any time?
Sure, it has to be on your turn. It just doesn't cost a bonus action, right?
Okay, that's what I thought. I was just making sure.
Yeah, don't forget to vote for MVP.
No one did too much.
Not really.
It's good to get those green circles.
I know.
We'll make it D-Lightning. What about that?
D-Lightning? He's not here. Here.
Yeah, no, but he still...
No, he doesn't need it. Kreese, what the fuck?
He did it in the bar.
Okay, but he doesn't need it. It would have to be one of us.
What about Drill Barrel or...
You guys will get these DM motivations as long as there's someone to get them.
Well, I don't know. Let's flip a coin, I guess.
I mean, the kid is unconscious and has 3 death saving throws.
We will.
Let's just give it to the kid then, so just in case.
Can the kid use it?
Yeah, he can reroll any 20. Throws. He can reroll any 20.
Yeah, I can stabilize him next turn, though.
Yeah, but it's better to have it just in case. He's still going to be low on health while we're fighting a lot of guys.
So. Well, yeah, but the stabilizing would just keep him from dying. Okay, yeah, we can give it to the kid. Fuck it.
Okay. I'm going to give it to the kid. Okay. All right. See you guys next Monday. You guys all heard me say you get 500 XP?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
I played it.
Already calculated it already.
Does the kid get 500 XP?
Remember, make sure you don't level your characters up. Just add the XP.
Yeah. Well, none of us are able to level up yet.
Yeah, the kid will get 500 XP, but I'm not giving him the 500 XP until we know he survives.
Okay. Okay. Cool.
And if he does level up, as of right now, he gets Bard.
Okay.
As a class he can level up into. So if you guys want that, you can add that as his class. That's why I'm saying don't level him up yet.
Could he just continue being fighter instead if he levels up?
Yeah, he can take a level 2 in fighter. But okay. Like I said, he can at any time he wants, he can take the class of Bard.
Nice.
Hey, it's me, Dan. After dealing with some local bandits and a freaking T-Rex, we discovered the leader of said bandits, the Raptor King himself. Wait, he wants to fight me? Okay, I'm down. Let's see what you got, lizard boy. Next time on One Piece D&D, Dan versus the Raptor King. See you next time.